Welcome to Oriel Park on this incredible spring day here in Dundalk for Dundalk's first pre-season match of the preparation for the 2021 season that kicks off in just a couple of weeks' time with the President's Cup match against Shamrock Rovers, and then just over a week later the first league game of the season away to Sligo Rovers. The Dundalk management team and the coaching team have been putting the players through their paces over the last number of weeks in preparation for the new season, and that preparation, it steps up a notch here this afternoon with the first pre-season match against one of the best sides in the country, undoubtedly in Bohemians FC, finishing second in the table last season. Alongside me, I'm delighted to say, on co-commentary here this afternoon is the Piemont United and Republic of Ireland striker Stephanie Roach. And Stephanie, I don't think I'm alone in saying that I'm really looking forward to seeing some live football and between two of the best squads in the country.
Yeah, exactly, and what a day for it. I think if nowhere else you want to be, is it? It's great to have this live football back and to be able to show the fans as well at home, so hopefully we get a good game today.
Bohemians do already have a pre-season match behind them. They played Shelburne last weekend and beat them by 2-0. This Dundalk's first pre-season match, as I said. Is that likely to mean that Dundalk are a step behind Bohemians in terms of their match sharpness?
Obviously, the game at hand is going to be, or a game ahead is going to be a little bit of an advantage, I suppose. But I think today both teams will be looking to maybe just get that match fitness. It's about getting yourself ready for when the season starts. I'd imagine the talk in the dressing room would be that the scoreline doesn't really matter. It's about the performance and, as I said, getting those minutes under your belt to go forward into the season in good shape.
We'll get a proper look at the teams when we go up into the gantry in just a few minutes' time. But one player that's starting for Dundalk this afternoon, it's Ryan O'Kane, young player, 17 years of age, signed his first contract with the club just last week, a three-year contract, which is a real statement of the belief that the club have in him. But it's a wonderful moment for him and his family. He's the grandson of a former Dundalk chairman. Really, it's a lovely moment for Ryan and for his family, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. And it's what football's all about, is especially in the community, to see a young player like that come through and play for his boyhood club. As you said, his grandfather obviously was chairman before as well, so there's a history with the club. And I'm sure he'll want to go out now and show what he's about today, and hopefully he can enjoy the game and get some good experience from it.
Plenty of changes in both squads in the close season, no doubt about that. Bohemians have had a couple of influential players leave and a couple of very influential players come in. And the same on the Dundalk side too. I think a lot of supporters have seen players go that have been a staple of the Dundalk team over the last number of seasons. But they too have had some fairly influential looking players come into the squad too.
Yeah, exactly. Lots of changes. So it's exciting to see all these players on show today. And it's a chance for them to show exactly what they're about as well. You know, it's a first chance for the fans to see the players in action. And I'm looking forward to it. There's a few players who, let's be honest, we don't know a whole lot about. We haven't seen a lot of them. So it'll be interesting to see how they get on today.
Yeah, I mentioned Ryan O'Kane, who, of course, signed a contract last week. Signing a contract this week, of course, the ex-Derry City and Sligo Rovers striker junior. And he adds to what is already an impressive array of options that Dundalk have going forward.
Yeah, exactly. And he's a tricky player. He's a proven goal scorer within the league, obviously, when he played for Derry as well. So, yeah, it's a great great addition to the squad. And I think when you look at that forward line, there's such a good mix of players. And it's an exciting thing to see. And we'll see today how they get on and how they mix well together. But, yeah, looking forward to watching the game and seeing Junior in action. Hopefully.
Looking forward to watching the game indeed. Fantastic conditions here in Oriel Park for a football match, as I said, between two of the best sides in the country, unquestionably. That's it for now, Stephanie. We're going to make our way up to the gantry for coverage of the first half here. While we do that, Dundalk media content officer Gavin McLaughlin caught up with new signing, centre-back signing, Sonny Nattestad during the week, and this is what he had to say.
Sonny, I think you've been here now 4 weeks. Looking forward to the real thing starting now today.
Yeah, looking forward to it. Been here for like you said, 3-4 weeks, and everything's been good. Training's a big. I've been in for a week with a small injury, but now back on the pitch and looking forward to the first couple of games and then the season.
Yeah, a lot of new players in. How have you all settled into the group?
No, really good. I did that the first day I came, I think. The guys were really nice and it was really easy. So they're like pretty similar to previous people. So it's, I'm happy to be here and so glad that the guys agreed with me. So.
Yeah. It must be strange because you've come to a new country and you've known Ollie, who plays in the same league, played in the same league as you in the Faroes last year. Have you built up a good relationship with him?
Yeah, I've been around a bit then, so I'm not like a stranger to move to a foreign country, but no, it's been nice, and with Ollie it's been also, of course it makes it easier that he comes from the Faroe Islands, not because he comes from the Faroe Islands, but he played there last year. So I knew him before, and it's a lot easier when he's here, and we hang out every day. So, not just him, all the guys as well. So all the other guys. So it's been easy. So
yeah. Does that make it easier that there's seven or eight new boys coming, and you know, for all of you, it's a chance to get to know people.
Yeah, that's the thing. We are like seven, eight new people. So it's easier.
Yeah, you obviously played against Ollie last year. What can we expect? We seen him in the Europa League playoff and he scored a brilliant goal. But what's he like? What's he like on the pitch?
On the pitch, he's tough to play against. I played against him a couple of times. He's really strong and he's actually fast compared to his size. And he has a good shot and he's good in the air. So I think we can expect a couple of goals from him. And that's what we want. And that's why he's here. So to score goals. So that's what we expect.
You mentioned the size. We've increased the height in the team this year. Something serious. We've seen players that are really tall and physical this season.
Me and Ole are definitely big.
Yeah.
So, but no, it's just an advantage. That's it. And we're gonna try to use it as much as possible, especially the defensive corners and set pieces and offensive as well. So.
Yeah. You're wearing a number 6 jersey this year?
Yeah.
Was there any reason behind that?
No, there was no story, just the numbers there. So I think it looked good, so
yeah,
that's why.
You've been here before. A lot of people might know that back in 2016 when Dundalk went on that brilliant European run, you were here with FH in the first qualifying round.
Yeah, I don't remember much of it, but I was here, I remember that. So I played the one here and the one in Reykjavik and in Iceland. So, but I actually didn't play those games. So I was on the bench. So, but I've been here.
Yeah, and obviously people will be looking. You're in Mold as well. Ole Gunnar Solskjær brought you to Norway. What was it like working under him?
Really nice guy. Really good coach. It's an honor for me to go to Molde as well. Unfortunately, I suffered a lot of injuries when I was there, but. That's how it is sometimes with football, but he's a really good coach, a really good lad as well. So
yeah. We've only got two friendlies before the President's Cup, so how important is this game against Bohemians to get off to a good start?
Yeah, of course, to get off to a good start is important, just to set our stamp down. We haven't trained that much and with the quarantine and everything, but hopefully we can get a good result tomorrow and look forward to the next friendly game at the end of the season.
Yeah, are you looking forward now when the fixtures come out a couple of weeks ago and you can see the season ahead? Are you looking forward now to just getting into that, you know, weekly games?
Yeah, exactly. I have like one league game, then I have to go with the national team straight away. So, but of course, first and foremost, I'm looking forward to play the league games and the cup game final as well, the 12th, I think.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
You come into a club, Sonny, with good centre-backs. What have you made of them? Andy Boyle, Daniel Cleary, Brian Gartland.
Really nice. First of all, really nice people and really nice footballer as well. So Andy, both Dan and Andy, they helped me a lot because they're the two that I play most with. So they both helped me a lot. Even Brian, who's in the dressing room.
Yeah.
The gym, injured. But it's really nice guys. Really good footballers.
Yeah. Well, listen, the very best of luck to you here.
Thank you.
Thanks a million.
Railway, which had its works here and which was the economic driver of Dundalk. And the men from the GNR started a football club. As you would expect, they called it the GNR Football Club. And that was the club which was admitted into the League of Ireland in 1926. And about 3 years afterwards, the members changed the name from the GNR to Dundalk. it was the 1960s really, the club developed a winning habit.
Hit very hard, it's in!
Magic, magical nights. We've experienced them then again to win the new championship. Football club can be an integral part of what makes the town.
To pitch side here at Oriel Park ahead of this Dundalk's first pre-season friendly of 2021. Bohemians FC, the opponents, and Dundalk could scarcely have asked for a more difficult opponent for their first pre-season friendly ahead of the new season. And that's really, Stephanie, what you want, isn't it? It's a test in these pre-season matches to really see where you are.
Yeah, exactly. You're going to play the best teams around the country. You're going to be coming up against them in the league, and they're the teams that you're going to be competing to finish higher up the table as well. Obviously, Bohs finished 11 points ahead of Dundalk last season. And so obviously Dundalk want to get closer to them this season, and I'd say both teams will be looking to push Shamrock Rovers again this year.
Yeah, Dundalk, there's no denying Dundalk have lost a couple of players and influential players over the last number of years in the close season, but they appear to have recruited very well. You know, they've brought in a couple of internationals. It'll be really interesting to see how the likes of Sonny Natastad and Rivas Jokovskis if they can hit the ground running with Dundalk this season.
Yeah, exactly. And I think over the years we've seen within the League of Ireland, it seems to be players kind of bounce from team to team, you know. And I think it's nice to see these international players wanting to come and play in the League of Ireland. This shows there's an interest around the world in the league, which is nice to see, you know. And I think interesting to see how they get on today. I think probably a little bit of an unknown entity, as we mentioned before, in terms of maybe a lot of people wouldn't have seen some of them, but international footballers playing in good leagues around the world, so I'm looking forward to seeing what they have to show today.
That's part of the exciting thing about the close season and the anticipation of a new season, and that is the new players and unknown quantities coming into the side. We'll get a look at the team sheet, at the Dundalk team sheet, just at the moment, and we do have some of those new players starting this afternoon. Alessio Abibi starting in goal this afternoon. Big gloves for him to fill this season after the retirement of Gary Rogers. Sonny Natastad comes in at centre-back. Rivas Jokovskis on the right-hand side of the defence. And Ole-Erik Mitzkogan as well into the forward line. So plenty for Dundalk fans to look forward to in the game today.
Yeah, exactly. We got a look at Ole-Erik Mitzkogan. Kogan, easy for you to say, in the Europa League. He obviously scored that goal. So look, a lot of players, as we said, Alessio Abibi coming in, Gary Rogers retiring, a big figure within the club, and within the League of Ireland, the legend really. So yeah, big gloves to fill, as you mentioned, and I'm just looking forward to seeing how they get on. Alessio Abibi, I spoke to him yesterday, he's played in Spain, he's played in Italy, he's got good experience around Europe, so good players coming in, and really, really tall players as well. Look at the size of them there in the warm-up. I think Sonny is 6'6", you know, so seems to be a trend within the squad, obviously a big strong physical squad, so good game to come forward.
That Dundalk lineup, incidentally, will line up in a 3-4-3 formation, we understand. So in goal, Alessio Abibi, Daniel Cleary, Andy Boyle, Sonny Natastad will be the centre-back three. We have Rivas Jokovskis on the right-hand side, Cameron Dummigan on the left-hand side. How important might he be this season after Dane Massey and Sean Gannon have left the club? Chris Shields, Greg Sloggett in centre midfield, Ole-Erik Mitzkogan on the right. Ryan O'Kane, who we mentioned a few minutes ago, young 17-year-old getting a start here this afternoon for Dundalk, and David McMillan, the FAI Cup final hero, through the middle. The Bohemians Football Club team this afternoon, they've made some changes as well this season. Again, some high-profile players coming into the side. Tyreek Wilson and Ali Cook coming in from Waterford. Two very good players. Saw them a number of times last year with Waterford. Bastian Eri, he's got great pedigree in the League of Ireland in midfield. And Liam Burton, ex-Celtic player on the right-hand side. So really good recruits for Bohemians in the close season.
Yeah, exactly. And not too dissimilar to Dundalk. They've lost quite a few players as well. A lot of maybe their forward line has changed. Bohemians like to play kind of quite direct, high-energy football, so it'll be interesting to see how these new players fit into their system. And as you mentioned, some very good signings, particularly Hare. I'm looking forward to seeing him back in the League of Ireland and playing football, so we'll see how they get on. But yeah, a lot of changes with both squads, so an interesting game coming up, and hopefully we get lots of entertainment.
I think everybody's really interested in seeing Bastian Eri back in the league. Such an accomplished footballer, you know, plenty of pedigree as well, you know, has had a time at PSG, did well over in the UK, did really well here with Limerick and Waterford, and then went north to Linfield. midfield. And I understand that they liked him in midfield, but it never really happened for him so much in Northern Irish football. It'll probably be good for him to go back to a brand of football and a country where he's comfortable and he knows he's done it before.
Yeah, exactly. And that happens. That happens to players. Sometimes they can go somewhere and it might not work out, but it doesn't mean it's the end of them. You know, he's coming back into a league, as you mentioned, that he's played in before, and he's shown the pedigree and he's shown that he has the quality to compete in this league. So I'm sure he'll be happy to get himself back playing the way he knows he can, and hopefully he can get back to his best for Bowes. Well, Bowes will be hoping he can anyway.
We understand that the Bohemians team will line out in a 4-3-3 system. So James Talbot in goal, the back four, Andy Lyons, Rob Cornwall, Kieran Kelly, Tyreek Wilson. In midfield, Keith Buckley, Bastien Arie and Keith Ward, the excellent dog player, of course. Liam Burt on the right-hand side of the front three. Ali Coote on the left-hand side. And a young striker signed from Shamrock Rovers in the close season as well, Thomas Alua, up front this afternoon for Bohemians. We're just getting ready and we're waiting for the players to re-emerge onto the pitch here. You mentioned the height of these Dundalk defenders. I don't think there's any denying Dundalk had problems on occasion in the second half of last season on set pieces. Perhaps that's something that the Dundalk management have looked at and decided to address in the close season.
Yeah, exactly. And I think it's a lot of changes within the squad, you know, a new management group coming in, working with the team and stuff. So maybe trying the kind of the zone on marking maybe takes a little bit of time to get used to, you know. And as you say, bringing in those tall players who are just, I suppose, strikers coming up against them, they'll put the fear of God into, you know. So it's the type of thing that you want to see them working on. And it seems to be, as you mentioned, something that they do feel they need to improve on, and they've brought in the players that they hope will be able to help improve that.
We will see a number of substitutes, obviously. It's a pre-season game. Incidentally, the two teams are emerging at the moment. Dundalk away to our left-hand side, and Bohemians are coming out of the main stand in front of us at the minute. And anticipation starting to build inside the ground. We don't have any supporters, but that is a real look. Everybody has spoken about it, Stephanie, over the last year, and what a shame it is to not have supporters in the ground. And I know we're very fortunate we're here, but it really isn't the same experience at all, is it?
No, it isn't. And as you say, I'm just delighted to be able to be out here and watch the game live, as you said. But it's nice to have the stream. It's nice for fans at home to be able to get a look at these new players and to be able to watch them. And as I said before, hopefully they get an entertaining game. But as you mentioned, it's pre-season. I think really what the players will be looking to do today is to get their fitness up and to get their sharpness back in the game. So it's I suppose not too much expected from the game, I don't think. But as I said, with the quality of players that both teams have brought in, you'd like to imagine we might get a little bit of entertainment as well along the way.
Both of these sides in their change kits here this afternoon. Bohemians in a white kit and Dundalk in that, what I think is a rather fetching new orange and black kit.
Yeah, I like it too. It's a little bit different, isn't it?
You're the fashionista here, Stephanie, not me. You can judge that one.
Yeah, I like it, I have to say. Now, I think it's a new little twang. The orange kind of gold going through it as well. So yeah, nice kits. Nice kits from both teams, to be fair.
Referee and the captains, Keith Buckley and, well, Chris Shields. It was. I noticed that over the close season, somebody put up a poll on Twitter as to who's the greatest player in Dundalk's history, and there are plenty of candidates for that, but Chris Shields would be chief among them.
Yeah, Chris is an excellent player. I watched him quite a lot in his younger days when he played at Bray Wanderers, and it's great to see him have come on as much as he has. I think he's always been that workhorse of a player who he'll give you everything, but he's also added the more technical passes. He's getting on the ball in holding midfield and trying to start attacks as well, which we've seen last season. So really, really good player and a great servant to the club.
It'll be the hat-trick hero from the FAI Cup final, David McMillan, to get us underway in just a moment. Lone player inside the centre circle. And as I said, Oriel Park absolutely bathed in sunshine here this afternoon. Wonderful game, really bright opening to the season in terms of weather. And let's hope from a Dundalk perspective and from a Bohemians one too that it's a bright season, and it's a bright season for the League of Ireland too. How we need it. Here's Dundalk with the early possession. Andy Boyle. And here's the new signing, Sonny Natastat. Imposing 6'6" centre back, current Faroe Islands international.
Yeah, I think we'll see Dundalk with a lot of the possession in the start, and I think Bowes will ease their way into it and, as I said, try to be a little more direct when they do get on the ball and get that ball forward quickly when they can.
There's some composed defending by Kieran Kelly on the edge of his own penalty area for Bowes, and goes long with it out towards this right hand side where Liam Burt is beaten in the air by Cameron Dummigan. I mentioned it in the build up to the game. He's very likely to see a lot more action for Dundalk, as he did last season, Cameron Dummigan. And a very accomplished player. next Northern Ireland international, of course.
Yeah, he showed at times last season just what he can do. He loves to come inside on his right foot and get involved with the play as well, so it'll be interesting to see how he can get on today.
Here's Rob Cornwall. Tyreek Wilson to Kieran Kelly once more. Kelly spent some of last season in Northern Ireland at Ballymena, a successful loan spell there after he perhaps had lost his way somewhat. But he's in the Bohemian starting lineup this afternoon and a chance to make a claim ahead of the new season. Craig Sloggett, a player who made his claim last season with some good performances. Had to, of course, control the Dundalk midfield in the absence of Chris Shields for such a vital game against Ki Klaksvík in the Europa League playoff. Andy Boyle now back in his old number four short, and that's not a bad ball. It's a good long one out to that right-hand side for Jakovskis, who's in advanced position. He's won the first corner of the game for the Lilywhites.
Yeah, it's a great ball, isn't it, by Boyle over the top. He almost finds him, but it's a good recovery and tackle, and here's a corner now, and a chance to see the height that Dundalk have on show here. Can they produce something from this corner kick?
Young Ryan O'Kay, 17 years of age, with this set piece for Dundalk. The big men are forward. Sonny Nattestad very likely to be a presence in there, and there's the flick on. Oh, and that's a chance at the back post. A real opportunity for Ole Eric Mitskogan to open his Dundalk account.
Yeah, it seemed like, well, maybe they worked on it, that front post run and a flick on at the back post. He just couldn't get enough on it. It just maybe hit him rather than him getting the contact he needed, but good delivery from the young man as well.
What an opportunity that was for Mitskogan, Dundalk's new striking recruit. Scored the Klaksvík consolation in the playoff defeat to Dundalk in the Europa League, and obviously did enough to convince the Dundalk management that he was worth making a move on in the close season. Bohemians now, and the Lions for Liam Burt, and he's claiming the free kick and he's not going to get it. Play on, and here's Cameron Dummigan forward with purpose now. Runs into the challenge of Cornwall, but it's broken for O'Kane with the cross in. It's not a bad cross, but the player that meets it is in a white shirt and Kieran Kelly.
Yeah, it's good work down this left-hand side from the two players there. A good little ball into the box. Stomachin carrying it forward as he loves to do. Maybe just ran out of ideas near the end there, but it worked out.
Real facet of Cameron Dummigan's play, his ability and willingness to get forward from his full-back position. He's got a throw in here. Greg Sloggett and Ryan O'Kane supplying support. So too Mitskogan. Dummigan looking for the smart back heel. Doesn't quite come off, and Bowes get it away. Alua beaten in the air by Nattestad, and here's Chris Shields taking over for Dundalk. Away by Kelly. Nattestad just encourages Dummigan to step out of it, and he meets it and finds Mitskogan. And I know we've spoken about the size and physique of some of these Dundalk players. Nattestad, obviously a very impressive specimen, but Mitskogan as well is a sizable player, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a player as well. He's quite good with his feet too as well. He's like to drop in and get on the ball. You've seen him here a few times looking for that ball to feet, but he's also a huge threat in the air too, and maybe the players around him can look to work off him too.
A touch for Alessio Abibi, former Albanian under 19 international, between the sticks for Dundalk here this afternoon and likely this season. Although Peter Cherry also re-signed for the club, might have something to say about that as the season progresses. Andy Boyle. Dan Cleary gets the head up and looks for the run of Mitskogan, and he's got Kieran Kelly for company. But Kelly uses his strength well.
Yeah, Kelly does well to see him out of play there. It's a good ball again. I think they're looking to try and get that switch on and get the play moving as quick as they can. Dundalk here, but really good defender from Kelly.
He looked a great prospect at St. Pat's, Kieran Kelly, and on loan at Drogheda, where he made a combined total of 55 starts in 2 years. He's in the Bowes squad this season. I do believe that Drogheda made a push to re-sign him ahead of the new season, but he's decided to stay, and Bowes value him enough to keep him in the squad.
Yeah, I think Keith Long has done really well to keep a good squad together, as I said before, getting in these players. He seems to get the best out of players, and players seem to really want to work for him, so I think that's a good coup for them to be able to keep Kieran Kelly here at the club.
Here's Dan Cleary. Not to start. Ryan O'Kane under pressure from a couple of Bowes players.
can't quite find a teammate, but Cameron Dummigan and David McMillan managed to engineer the ball loose for O'Kane. O'Kane now with the chance to cross it, and just off target with the cross, but certainly on his first appearance for Dundalk, no shortage of confidence in young O'Kane.
Exactly, yeah, I think I saw a little nutmeg in there as well, didn't we? Yeah, Dummigan and O'Kane down this left-hand side seem to be given these balls, this right-hand side of Bowes a hard time, but O'Kane, as we said, not short on confidence, and he just needs to maybe work on that final ball, but he's doing all the right things starting off in the start of this game.
Just over 6 minutes played, and I think the Dundalk management for a first pre-season friendly will be happy with how Dundalk have started.
Yeah, it's been a quiet enough start, hasn't it? Just trying to keep possession, as we said before, move the ball quickly and try to create those little bits of space to get those forward players into. But yeah, good start so far.
Cameron Dummigan's header. Kelly returns it, and Dummigan likewise once more. Mitch Cogan with the flick on. Rob Cornwall. And a chance now for Tyreek Wilson. Wilson once more, and now Keith Buckley, the Bohemians captain. Here's Thomas Alua to test Andy Boyle for pace and strength, and well, ball didn't really favour Alua, and Boyle very much in control.
Yeah, he done very well to shepherd it out. He saw the danger early and got across and didn't give him a chance to get turned. Really good defending, really good cover from Andy Boyle, as you said.
Thomas Alua spent much of last season in the First Division with the Shamrock Rovers B side, scored 4 goals in 12 First Division appearances. And he scored in Bohemians' first pre-season friendly last weekend too. Another new signing, Liam Burt with the other goal. Greg Sloggett. Abebe. Andy Boyle keen to take the ball from the Dundalk goalkeeper. Here's Greg Sloggett now on the half turn to David McMillan, and Cameron Dummigan calls for it on the left hand side and receives it. Burt back trying to bar his route forward. That's a really good cross in by Cameron Dummigan. Good area.
That's a great ball. Great ball. Needs someone attacking that into that space. It's a position you want as a striker. I think you need that to gamble and make that run across the 6-yard box. But great ball coming in on his right foot, as we mentioned before. He likes to do that. And just before that as well, we heard Bowes, Kieran Kelly scream at them to get up the pitch. Maybe need to play a little bit higher and push their team to try and get forward a little bit more, because they're maybe giving Dundalk a little bit too much time on the ball.
James Talbot with the clearance away. Mitch Cogan up for Dundalk. Back to his goalkeeper by Kieran Kelly. Talbot. Here's Wilson now. Down goes, well, it'll be a free kick. Keith Ward, it was the offended player.
Yeah, I think the new signing there, Jer Cross, is just a little bit too eager to get in there and get forward, which you'd like to see. Maybe just a little bit too eager, though.
He is that sort of a player, Rivas Jurkowskis. Does like to spend time in the opposing half. As does that man, Cameron Dummigan, getting in there in front of Liam Burt. That'll be a throw-in to the visiting side. Andy Lyons. Chris Shields uses his body well to take over the possession for Dundalk, but they've given it away. Here's Tyreek Wilson. Now Ali Coote. This is better from Bowes. But Bastianeri just a little loose in possession. And there's a turnover for Dundalk. Here's Greg Sloggett to Chris Shields. Protects it well. And now Nattestad. People listening in and watching in this afternoon from all over the world, we're told. Hong Kong, Fort Lauderdale in the US and Australia. Some of the locations that are tuned in today. Good afternoon to you all.
Yeah, it's great to see, isn't it? The League of Ireland being watched all over the world. And it's hopefully something that we'll see throughout the season, I think. Bringing these players from all over Europe, and as you mentioned, people in Australia and America wanting to watch the League of Ireland, it can only be good for the league here itself, and to shine a spotlight with the quality that is in this league, you know.
I say good afternoon to you all. I have no idea what time it is in your countries. It's Dan Cleary now with the lofted one forward. Mitch Cogan just loses the flight of it. It'll break here though for Dundalk. play by McMillan. Might be an opportunity here. Certainly an opportunity to cross it. And Dundalk have their second corner kick of the game.
Yeah, it's a good combination play from them three again, isn't it? They seem to be working down that side quite a bit. And another corner coming in here. Can O'Kane get a good delivery? And Dundalk looking to try and, as I said, make their height advantage count.
Most of the play in this first half so far inside the Bohemians' half of the pitch. Here's the corner kick from Dunnigan. And not just that, well, he's a player you don't want attacking the ball and getting a free header inside your penalty area, but way off target with his attempt. Ball a little bit behind him, I think.
Yeah, probably just a little bit off balance. And as you say, the ball slightly behind them. But again, you don't want to leave him with too much space within that box, do you?
Here's Wilson now. It's Cogan scrapping and emerging with the ball. He's done well. The Norwegian, he's gone down. Dundalk felt that was a free kick. Bohemians undeterred continue. Here's Andy Lyons. Now Burt. Now Eri breaking into the Dundalk half, and Natastad looks in control here. A BB just cuts across the ball to deliver it into midfield. Dave McMillan felt there was a little push from Rob Cornwall. Referee doesn't see it that way. Here's Wilson now. It's not a bad ball for Alua. He's got Andy Boyle though. And Boyle defends it well. Chris Shields for Domigan. Okay. Dan Cleary. Shields. So many towering performances last season, particularly in Europe. Some really fine performances when it was difficult for Dundalk at times with the schedule of games that they had. It was really difficult for at times in Europe to put out the strongest team or to keep the strongest team on the pitch for the 90 minutes. And well, Chris Shields though, and I have to say Pat Hoban as well on occasions too, really rose to the challenge. And so many of the players as well.
Yeah, I think the two players you mentioned are a big part of the squad, aren't they? I think, as you said, big demands on the squad to play in the league and in Europe, especially when they're playing against the quality of teams of Arsenal and Rapid Vienna, teams that really do pose a difficult task for them. So a really, really high demand on the squad last season, and they'll be looking to go even further this year, I'm sure.
Free kick to the Lily Whites. The Dundalk captain looks to be the player too. Take the responsibility. Here's Andy Boyle now. Chris Shields again. Now Domigan. Burt working back well defensively for Bohemians. Throw in for Dundalk now. Cameron Domigan just waiting for a reasonable option to present itself, which it eventually does. And Domigan all the way back to Abebe, and Dundalk will try and start again. Shields for Dan Cleary. Scored his first ever European goal last season for Dundalk in that 3-1 win over Klaksvik in the Europa League playoff. What an occasion to get your first goal in Europe. Kieran Kelly on some good defending under pressure from Mitch Cogan.
Yeah, it's good pressure high up the pitch from Mitch Cogan is what you want from your wide forward players to really make a nuisance of yourself and try and get your team up the pitch, and done well to win that throw in there.
He does look like a player who terrorised defences in terms of work rate, if nothing else. Oh. There's a really good turn, and what an effort that was. And a really good save by James Talbot as well. But acrobatics by David McMillan. Wonderful first touch and a wonderful effort.
That's fantastic effort. He's very unlucky. I think it just didn't dip maybe late enough. I think Talbot got a great touch on it. Very, very good save from the keeper. Did he get a touch? Just about. Yeah, he did. Really, wow. Really good effort from McMillan, as you mentioned. Acrobatic. Unfortunate not to see
punched
that go in.
By Talbot, but what an effort that was by David McMillan. Absolutely superb. And that is the thing with David McMillan, isn't it, Stephanie? He scores such a variety of goals.
Yeah, he's a forward who brings different types of goals, and that's kind of what you want. You want a player who's going to be scoring tap-ins but also has that in his locker as well, you know. So really, really good in the final last year, as we mentioned before as well. To get the hat-trick was a great achievement for him, but really, really good striker, and as we said, can score all types of goals, which is good for Dundalk.
Strong play by Rob Cornwall. Here's Keith Buckley. Cornwall again.
I think Bowes just really need to look to try to keep the ball a little bit. They probably haven't really had a chance to get their kind of entertaining players on the ball just yet, the likes of Array and even Bert over on this right-hand side has spent most of this first half so far defending and hasn't had a chance to get on the ball and show what he's about.
Dundalk free kick now. Chris Shields. Andy Boyle. Dave McMillan just drops but can't link up with the ball. Keith Buckley has given that away. Shields is a big shout man on by his teammates and he's aware of the presence of Bastianeri. Sonny Nattestad now. That David McMillan, well, I almost called it a chance. It almost wasn't a chance. He conjured something out of nothing. The first real opportunity that either side have had in this game, really, the first really significant one. Here's Dan Cleary. Jurkowskis checking back. Chris Shields once more. These teams played a friendly, incidentally, before the restart last year in July. 4-1 and finished to the Lily Whites on that occasion. Jordan Flores, Dane Massey, Sean Gannon and Patrick Hoban with the goals. Oma Sher with the consolation for Bowes on that occasion. Dundalk 2 won by the same margin in the FAI Cup last season. But Bowes enjoyed the upper hand in the league, beating Dundalk 2-1 at Dalymount after the restart. And a brilliant performance, I have to say. They were absolutely fantastic on the day. I think Sean Gannon had twisted blood. Chris Twardek gave him a really torrid time that day.
Yeah,
it was really good strength by Alua, and he's managed to give the Dundalk defenders the slip. A BB out to hold him up. So too Cameron Domigan. He did really well there, Thomas Alua. Great strength too, and skill too, to turn away from the Dundalk defenders. But Dundalk have defended the problem. Andy Lyons can't quite control that. Away by Nattestad.
That's better from Bowes. So they want to try and get Alua on the ball. It's probably going to... The start of this game has probably been a bit of a thankless job. He's just running around. But they can keep possession and try and get him into positions. He's a big, strong guy and he will try and make things happen.
Keith Buckley. Now Rob Cornwall. Drumcondra man in his fifth season with Bowes after spells with Shells, Derry and Shamrock Rovers. That's a good pass by Keith Ward. And Liam Burt just can't shake off Cameron Domigan, who started well in this game here, Domigan.
Yeah, he's been aggressive, hasn't he? He's not letting Burt get any time to turn. I think himself and Boyle down this right-hand side are having a tough time with Domigan and O'Kane really just getting at them and not giving them that chance to show what they can do going forward.
Daniel Cleary with a defender's pass forward. He'll be disappointed with that. He's capable of much, much better, Daniel Cleary. He does love a long diagonal.
Yeah, he's just looking for his range, I think, isn't he?
Keith Buckley into midfield for Ali Coote. Here's Wilson. Coote and Wilson combining in Bowes shirts. They were both in Waterford shirts, of course, last season.
You can see the idea there from Herreys. It's probably the first time we've seen him get on the ball and get turned, but just that... Not enough on that true ball.
What an encouraging run this is by Jurkowskis. Really good. And he's carried on into the penalty area. He's found Mitz Kogan here onto that left foot. The shot is well blocked. And a Bohemians player seems to have come off the worst. I think it's Ali Coote who's gone down. But what a run that was by Jurkowskis.
Yeah, really, really good run. Wasn't it powerful? And laced the ball off at the right time as well. Probably a little bit greedy, I think, from to try and shoot from that angle, but he's won a corner again here, and as you said, we can maybe see Sonny come up here and maybe get a little bit better contact than he did before, but really good play down that right-hand side once again.
Well, if that's what Rivas Jurkowskis is capable of, Dundalk may not miss Sean Gannon. That was very Gannon-like, that run.
Yeah, let's hope Coote is okay here now. Seems to be holding his ankle. Hopefully it's nothing too serious. It's not what you want to see in a pre-season game.
Bedford-born Ali Coote in England, but brought up in Scotland and represented the Scots internationally at underage levels. He scored in the 2-0 win over Bowes in September for Waterford last season. And the other scorer on that day was Tyreek Wilson, who's also a Bowes player now. If you can beat him, join him, seems to be the adage there. It'll be a Dundalk corner kick.
He seems to be okay, which is good to see, just running it off there. He'll be looking to get back on as fast as he can.
And it's a high looping one, and Natastat meets it. It just drops underneath the crossbar, and James Talbot can collect it comfortably enough. But once again, Natastat the target in the penalty area.
Yeah, he's getting closer, isn't he? I think he said he's a handful to mark. I think they're going to have to really, really try and avoid giving away those corners if they can, because he's, as we said, he's getting closer with everyone so far.
Well, with his imposing size, there's no doubt that he'll be a presence in both penalty areas. The question will be how good he is on the ground, Sonny Natastat, and only time will tell. We may get some answers to that question as the afternoon here progresses. Bohemians with a free kick now. And they decide not to send forward the centre-backs. They're going to work it short. Here's Keith Ward. That's a good ball by Ward. In for Airy. And BB comes out. So too there was Greg Sloggett to make sure the ball was smuggled behind for a corner kick for Bohemians. But, well, no surprise to see Keith Ward at the heart of that. Another smart pass by him, and it almost offered Bowes an opportunity.
Yeah, it's a great ball. Maybe just a little bit too much. It carried on the turf, didn't it? But a really, really good idea.
Here's Ali Coote, and he's allowed some space to size this up. Oh, and it's come back off the post. Well, Dundalk just allowed Coote too long, and he almost took full advantage. But the post saving Dundalk.
Yeah, it's a great strike, isn't it? I don't know if it got a deflection coming through there, which just helped Dundalk, I think, but it's a great strike. You can't be allowing him that much space around the edge of the box.
Fantastic strike by Coote. Here it is again.
Yeah, it's much better by Bozo as well, isn't it? They're trying to get on the ball. They're really trying to impose himself. Oh, comes back there and he just can't get the contact on it.
So a half chance perhaps for Airy a moment ago, and then Ali Coote striking the post. Here's Airy again. He's got a player on the right-hand side in space, Andy Lyons. Quickly closed down by Domigan. But that's a really good ball in by Lyons. And it needed defending there by Andy Boyle.
Yeah, it's the first time we've really seen Lyons getting forward, isn't it? I think he's really started to come into his own the last couple of seasons with Bowes after taking over really from Derek Pender when he retired in 2019. But first time we've had a chance to see him get forward and good ball. I think this will open the game up a little bit more with Bowes getting forward.
Here's the corner kick now for the visitors. Both arms raised in the air by Burton. He takes it short to Ward, and Ward's pass back to him is a little short too. And Cameron Domigan, as Stephanie said a few minutes ago, aggressive in the tackle, brings it away, but he's run into traffic. There's the cross from Burt, but way too close to a baby.
Yeah, he's trying to get it into Aliyah as quick as he can there. I think it's just a little bit too rushed, but as I said before, better from Bowes. They're trying to get on the ball higher up the pitch, which I think they need to do.
Plenty of comments coming in on Twitter. We have a listener in Lima in Peru. It's 7:18 a.m. Thank you for that information. That's important information. Sir Sipakman, thank you very much. Grazer is listening in this afternoon as well. Here come Dundalk. Good cross in by O'Kane. Away by Wilson. Alua picks up the loose ball for Bohemians. And Wilson looking for Keith Buckley's feet. But Chris Shields wins it back for Dundalk. Sluggard for Shields into the feet of McMillan, just helps it on the one out there in it.
That's a good idea. It's unlucky. I think he's looking for that ball around the corner. We say we've seen that link up play down the right hand side, but really good ball from Chris Shields into his feet, but just an unfortunate touch. It just had a little bit too much on it from McMillan. But down that right hand side, they seem to be dangerous, and they're really trying to pick Bowes off down that side. But better game, I think, is starting to open up a little bit more. As I said, Bowes coming into it, they're looking to try and impose themselves on the game, and then they've settled into it, I suppose. They've weathered the storm in the first 15 to 20 minutes from Dundalk. But
Ted is listening in the UK as well, and he says he's enjoying the coverage. Very slick and professional, he says, and I presume he's speaking about Stephanie.
I don't know about that. You're making me look good here, Adrian.
Here's Andy Boyle. Chris Shields here. Now Cleary. Shields again. Jurkowskis protecting it, winning the throw-in. Now Cleary. Notice that. Shields under pressure from Keith Buckley, just uses his body well, and Buckley drawn into the foul. Smart play by the Dundalk captain up against the Bowes one.
I think you can Mike see Dundalk really trying to keep their width very well. I think Dummigan's hugging this touchline out here, and also on the opposite side you can see they're really trying to spread the play and make that pitch big for them when they're in possession.
That's a really good touch by Burke to bring him away from Dummigan. Alua and Chris Shields crashes into a challenge and wins it back. Ryan O'Kane from McMillan. McMillan looking to toe poke it back to O'Kane again. Mitskogan can't take the possession, and Aree finds Wilson.
It's great feet from Aree, isn't it? Really showing his quality there. Nice little drag past McMillan as he comes in for a tackle. But
Cornwall. Now Aree, lovely turn by Aree, draws Shields into the foul.
He's starting to enjoy it, isn't he? He's trying to get on the ball a little bit more, Aree here. But Chris Shields, obviously not a player to let him mess about too much, so he won't get too much time on the ball.
A real signing for Bowes supporters to get excited about. Bastian Aree. Is the cross in cut out by Boyle. Kieran Kelly, his control just lets him down. Here's McMillan now, and Shields sweeps that out to this left-hand side looking for Ryan O'Kane, and his first touch doesn't let him down. Dummigan.
Yeah, you can see Lyons getting nice and tight to O'Kane. He knows what he's about now. He doesn't want to let him get that run on him, but it's good defend to force him back. And Dundalk, as we said before, keeps switching the play and looking for that opening to try and get through and create that chance.
Former Balergan United player Ryan O'Kane. Great to see a local player in the Dundalk team, isn't it?
Yeah, brilliant. And as we said, it's a great opportunity for him here in the first match of pre-season to really show what he can do and try to impress the management here and get a chance to get into the team going forward.
Boyle. Nicely judged to the right boot of Cameron Dummigan. Now Shields. Slog it. Boyle. There's a run in off that right wing by Jurkowskis that Boyle decides not to use. Dundalk throw in. Cleary for Mitskogan. Talbot. Disappointing clearance by the Bowes Player of the Year in 2019, James Talbot.
Yeah, James is a good lad. He was at Sunderland when I was there, and he was just making his breakthrough into the team and decided to come back to Ireland and play in the League of Ireland, and he really has gone from strength to strength since coming back, which is great to see.
They have two really good goalkeepers in Stephen McGuinness and James Talbot. Very blessed in that position.
Yeah, exactly. Lots of competition, which is always good as well. Both keepers pushing each other all the time.
And they've signed Enda Minogue too from Bray to offer some competition. That's a lovely turn by Burt. Very clever indeed to bring him away from Chris Shields and Cameron Dummigan. This time conceding the free kick to Bowes.
Yeah, the Bowes new signings really starting to try and show their quality going forward. As I said before, they kind of were under pressure, under the cosh going forward, or defending, as I said, at the start of the game, but they're really starting to come in with Liam Burt getting on the ball and Hooray really showing what they can do. But it's a free kick in a good position.
Tyreek Wilson, the left footer, standing over this. Ali Coote, the right footed option. Alessio Abebe making plenty of noise on his line. And there's the shot, and it's not a bad one, and it draws a good save from Abebe. It was Tyreek Wilson with the effort.
Very, very good. First time he's really been called upon, apart from the one that hit the post, really, isn't it? I think it's a good save. He gets down low and gets a good left hand on it and pushes it away for a corner kick, but really good save from a good strike.
Liam Burt with the corner kick. He's starting to look more influential in a white shirt here. Drills it across. Abebe comes and punches that well.
That's good, I think, for Abebe to do that as well. I think coming from Europe, maybe people think he's more of a shot stopper. Coming out for crosses like that will be something that he'd be tested on a lot in the League of Ireland here. So showing a bit of strength coming out there and clearing that with a good punch away from goal.
Good opening half hour for Alessio Abebe in a Dundalk shirt. A good opening half hour for most of the debutants here this afternoon.
Really good forward player from McMillan there, isn't it? I think his team under pressure a little bit, and he doesn't give Cornwall time on the ball, and he wins the free kick for his team. Very, very good play from him.
Here's another stat. Now Domigan. Burt walking back. Now Ryan O'Kane. First touch, head up, cross in, really good. Just a little bit too much height on it for Mitz Cogan.
Yes.
But a good delivery again.
Very, very good ball coming in. I think Dummigan going down the left-hand side ahead of him, he was always going to cut back, wasn't he? And O'Kane's ready for that setback, and it's a good cross in. Just a little bit too high for Mitz Cogan, as you mentioned. I think it's good to see from both teams, so I think both squads and new players really seem to be settling into the team quite well and showing what they're about. I think it's been a good kind of half an hour so far from both teams.
More messages from around the world. Rosengarten, Lower Saxony. A nice bit of sunshine there, apparently, according to Paul Flatt on Twitter.
Getting a bit of sunshine ourselves here today, aren't we? It's a lovely day in Dundalk. It's been kind of gloomy and dull the last couple of weeks, especially being in lockdown, so it's nice to see that sunshine coming out and the spring coming in.
League of Ireland football is a little closer to coming back. Of course, things are brighter. Here's Sluggett. And he's given that away cheaply. Here's Liam Burt onto it. He's got Alua on his outside. Burt fancy going his own way, and he does, and he's drilled that pass a baby. Nothing the Dundalk keeper could do about it, but Liam Burt showing what he's all about, breaking forward and drilling that home. And Bohemians lead by a goal to nil.
Yeah, it's sloppy by Slogger. He won't be happy with that crossfield ball. I think we've mentioned Dundalk maybe being quite wide when they're in possession, but that's kind of the danger you have, that if you do give it away, the space is in the middle to pounce upon, and Bert has done really well. It's a good steal in the middle, and he's gone forward and he's finished really well, as you said. Abebe really couldn't do a lot, could he?
The loose pass really did open up the pitch for Bert, didn't it?
Exactly, and that's the risk when you're playing this type of football for Dundalk. They're trying to spread the play, they're trying to really get at balls going forward, but it does leave you exposed a little bit if you give balls away. So as I said, Sluggett won't be happy with that, but he won't take away from the finish from Liam Burt. Really good finish.
United Arab Emirates, hello to you. Frankie watching in Sharjah. It's 16:30 there, 4:30 in the afternoon in the United Arab Emirates. And again, thank you to you and the more locally based Dundalk supporters too. Let's not forget them as well, how we wish they were here. And let's hope that before the end of the 2021 season that you are. Andy Boyle drills that long, but too straight and too close to James Talbot. Cornwall. Now Kieran Kelly. It's been a decent enough game. We've had a couple of decent chances and a goal here, Stephanie,
yeah,
in this first half.
It has. And as we said before, I think it's obviously Bows have played one game already, but Dundalk's first game in pre-season. So I think the purpose of these games is really to get your match fitness up and sharpness back. But there has been some really good bits of play at times, which is good to see.
Bohemians throw-in. Going to have a change here for Dundalk.
Mitz Cogan.
And it's Ole Eric Mitz Cogan, the player to make way. And it's Jesus Perez who will replace Mitz Cogan. A forward player, an attacking player for an attacking player.
Yeah, early substitution, as we said, pre-season game. I'd say you're going to see a lot of changes throughout the game, giving players a chance to get their match fitness up. But a good showing from Mitz Cogan. I think he showed sparks of what he could do and linked up well down that right-hand side with McMillan. And
that will be interesting in the coming season, just how Dundalk will use the likes of Mitz Cogan, Dave McMillan, Patrick Hogan Jr. You know, I said it before the game, it's an embarrassment of riches. It's a real question for the Dundalk management, how they use them all.
It is, you're right, and I think it's great, a great problem to have, isn't it? As I said before, the game, all different types of players who'll fit into different kind of systems as well, so it'll be interesting to see who they settle on going into the start of the season.
It's a nice problem to have, and I don't think that there's another club in the country with that sort of strength in that area of the pitch. How Dundalk use it? Well, if they get it right, It'll be entertaining to watch, no doubt, and it's good for the league.
Yeah, and it's about getting that practice together as well. A lot of these players just getting to know each other as well. As we say, first game of the season or first game of pre-season. So it might take time for them to gel together, but as we said, it's a good range of different types of players and exciting players, players who can hold the ball up, players who can run with the ball. So really, really good options for Dundalk's management going into the season.
Keith Long too, with plenty of good options in all areas as well. They have been active in the close season.
Yeah, we spoke about some of the players that have gone from Dundalk. I think if you look at Bo's team, Danny Grant, excellent for them last season. It'd be a big loss to them also, forwards like Dinny Corker and Andre Roy. Lost some players going out of the club, but you've also got some good talent coming in. So again, they're in the same position, looking to try and gel their players together.
Georgie Kelly, of course, the ex-Dundalk player, has pitched up now. Here's Ryan O'Kane. This could be a great moment for O'Kane. And he's just put it the wrong side of the post. But a real chance for the youngster to level things up here. He just found himself in behind the post defence.
Yeah,
and maybe composure slightly letting him down just at the last moment.
I think he's just dragged it wide, didn't he? Maybe think it could have gone on his left foot, but I think it just falls for his right foot and it just goes the wrong side of the post for him. But good run, I suppose, good positive play from him again. So he's shown what he can do, and he's getting into those centre positions now as well, where he can get chances on goal. But unfortunate to see that.
So impressed with his confidence, Stephanie.
Yeah, definitely for a young lad. He's obviously got the backing of the coaching staff and the players around him. You can see Dumigan trusts him. He's giving him the ball. He wants him to do what he's good at. So really, really good start from the young lad, as we said. And just unfortunate that didn't go in. It would have been a nice moment for him.
He has played senior football. He spent some time in the Northern Irish League with Cliftonville and before that Warren Point, where he made his first team debut at 15. So his abilities were very definitely very evident from very early on.
Yeah, he nearly making a good run there again. He's intelligent play. He's watching the runner McMillan dropping in. And he sees that space that he's leaving, and he's trying to get into those areas. And if he keeps doing that, he may get his opportunity again to get on goal. But intelligent player. He seems to watch the play and want to get on the ball, but he's also working off the ball to get into good positions.
We're continuing to be flooded with messages from people all over the world, and I'm starting to doubt that some of them are in the countries that they say. Here's Thomas Alua, and once again, Cameron Dumigan coming in from left full back to make up the numbers inside the penalty area, and some more good defending by the Lurgan man.
Yeah, it wouldn't be like Twitter to see messages like that coming through. It could be starting a trend, maybe, have we?
Here's Natastat. Andy Boyle. We were speaking a moment ago about the Bohemians options. Georgie Kelly, of course, now a Bohemians player. Maybe didn't set the world alight at St Patrick's Athletic, as Cameron Dumigan controls that crossfield ball really well. Here's Ryan O'Kane. Two Bowes players in his way, but once again, the cross is excellent by Ryan O'Kane. He has a wonderful right foot.
They're doing so well to open that space as well. Both right-footed players, and you think, as a defender and a winger, just keep them on their left foot, but they're still managing to shift it and get those great balls into the box. But I think Andy Lyons and Liam Burt have their hands full down this left-hand side, but just maybe not making the right runs at times to get on the end of those crosses. So it might come, hopefully, for Dundalk in the second half. But really good, positive play from them both again.
Bose fans, I am trying to talk about your team. Georgie Kelly, for the third
we'll get there.
Is now a Bose player, of course. And again, he may well not have set the world alight at St Pat's last year, but I think that here at Dundalk, we saw huge evidence that he's a natural goal scorer. And he was feeding off scraps with Dundalk, with Pat Hoban ahead of him in the team. And he scored so many goals a couple of years ago. I think Bowes have a proper striker there.
Yeah.
And a player who scores goals.
Yeah, definitely. As you mentioned, he's proven himself before here at Dundalk. Goal scorer, he'll get in good positions and he'll get that option up front. As you said before, a lot of changes within that Bowes forward line. So chances for him coming in to get game time and really show what he can do again in the League of Ireland.
Here's Chris Shields, strong, powerful, across Ali Coote to see that out for a corner kick for Dundalk. We have just under 5 minutes to go to the break. Dundalk trailing by a goal to nil. Liam Burt with the finish on 33 minutes. And Ryan O'Kane gets another opportunity to utilise that right boot. Dundalk big men are in there, as you'd expect, to the front post this time. Flicked on. Still there for a Dundalk player, should they manage to make a connection with it. Chris Shields from distance on his left foot. Blocked by Alua. David McMillan. Blocked by Keith Buckley. Dundalk still with the possession. Ryan O'Kane. blocked by Buckley. O'Kane into the penalty area. Well done, O'Kane. Shot saved by Talbot. And Bowes should get it away. But good stuff again by Dundalk. And good stuff again by the youngster.
Yeah, it's good high pressure, isn't it? They're not letting them settle. They're not letting them get that ball cleared. Kind of bounced around a little bit there between Shields and McMillan, but O'Kane showing real composure to come inside and get that shot off, and he's unfortunate that it didn't. Talbot pams it away to safety rather than to a Dundalk player coming in.
Jurkowskis now with the throw-in. Slog it. Another throw-in to Dundalk. Tyreek Wilson toe-poking it away for Bowes. Chris Shields. Here's Andy Boyle now. Now not to stat. McMillan. Not a stat.
You can see McMillan dropping again there, and they're just looking to fill that space.
Here's Jurkowskis with the cross in. Well dealt with by Kieran Kelly. Chris Shields. Shields looking for the throw in, and he gets it. Here's Perez. Now the cross from Dan Cleary. Away by Cornwall. Coot now. Now Burt. Just checks back away from Domigan. Holds on to it and finds Buckley. Good ball by Buckley to Keith Ward now on the left hand side. Pops up in all sorts of positions, Keith Ward. It's that irrepressibility. That's such an asset of his. So creative. Here's Buckley now. Ward once more.
You can see the shouts from the sideline there to go forward. Ward goes back with the ball there. They're looking to try and get up the pitch a bit quicker than maybe they are. I think shouts from the sideline.
Ali Coote getting more and more involved in the game. Ward to Lua. Now Burt and the Lions. Ryan O'Kane. Bohemians throw in. Here's Coote again now. Tyreek Wilson. Now Kelly again as we enter the final minute of the opening 45.
That's calm play from Cormo of the back heel and the last line of defence there. Showing quite a bit of confidence.
Alua. Well, that's a good ball by Alua. And Keith Ward. Andy Boyle straining to get across to him. And he's done well, Boyle. And he's claiming the throw-in. I think the assistant and the referee will disagree with his judgment.
I think he's chancing his arm there, isn't he? It's good cover again, though, by Boyle. He spots the danger early and gets across and covers Ward. But it's a good run as well. So more positive play again from Bowes getting forward.
Here's Wilson now with the throw-in. Can Bowes stretch their advantage before the break? Ari for Wilson again. Kieran Kelly. Cross from Wilson is a low one. And, well, whether by accident or design, Dundalk let that run across the penalty area now. And that's the final whistle of the first half from the referee. And it's a first pre-season match, remember, of 2021 for Dundalk. And at the break, after a fairly even, I think, first half, it's Dundalk nil, Bohemians 1. Sum up the first half for Stephanie.
Yeah, as you said, I think it's been quite even. I think Dundalk maybe started the better, put a two bows, but all credit to them. They kind of, as we said before, I wouldn't say it was a weather the storm is probably the wrong phrase to use, but they kind of kept themselves in the game and they were able to show their qualities going forward with that finish from Liam Burt. But yeah, a really even game. And as you said, good bit of quality within the game as well, which is good to see it this early in pre-season.
And I know the goal from Bohemian supporters' perspectives will be the highlight of the game, but for me, the highlight of the first half, that David McMillan effort.
Yeah, great effort, wasn't it? And the acrobatic, you're thinking he's not going to do it, and it's just unfortunate it doesn't dip under the bar. And as I mentioned, it's a good touch by Tal, but yeah, but really, really good effort. And as I said, good quality within the game, and moments of real quality at times. So hopefully we'll get more of the same in the second half.
That's it for the first half. We will be back, of course, with the second half in about 10 or 15 minutes' time. To take you through the interval, we've got some ads lined up and an interview with Ali Mithal from club sponsors Bet Regal. But first up is this piece that Stephanie recorded with Dundalk goalkeeper Alessio Abibi on Thursday.
Okay, I'm joined today by Alessio Abibi, the new number one at Dundalk. Thanks a million for agreeing to come on and speak to us, Alessio. How are you?
Hi Stephanie, hi to everyone. I'm good, and I'm ready to start the games starting from tomorrow, and I can't wait for it.
Yeah, it's great to get going in pre-season. It's all about the games, then hopefully the season comes ticking fast. How have you been finding life in Dundalk? How's training been going for you in pre-season?
It's very good, very good. First impressions are so good. I'm now improving my English, so I start to communicate a little bit more with all the guys and everybody here. So I'm happy, and nothing, just now we wait for the games.
Just adjusting to life, I suppose, yeah. I had the same experience. I played in Italy recently, so I'm sure you're still getting used to all the different accents and different things that people are coming out with in training. How are you getting on with Graham and his Dublin accent?
yeah, it was not so easy for me. It's not easy to understand when the lads speak to each other, you know? Yeah. I'm like concentrate to understand something, but it's too difficult to ask for me, and I always ask to speak slow, you know, to explain me. But no, it's okay. Now I'm in the house with one England and Greg and Junior, the new guy. So I have to speak English, and this thing I think will help me to improve, you know.
Yeah, definitely. It's good to be around people who speak the English language.
Where do you play it before in Italy?
I played in Florence.
Ah, good, huh?
In this women's Serie A, yeah. I came back actually just last year in February. It was just at the start of the whole coronavirus. So I'm playing back in Ireland now. But yeah, I know what you're going through. I know the difference in cultures and even the accents. Like there was
a lot of difference. Yes, a different life.
Yeah, it's a difficult one. So no, I admire you. It's a different thing to come and play in a different country. So fair play to you. Get into the game tomorrow, I suppose. First match of pre-season, you're playing Bohemians. Are you looking forward to getting onto the pitch finally, and I suppose playing with the team and getting to know the lads in a game setting?
Yes. It would be good to see in what point we are, you know, because, okay, we train hard, we work hard every day, but we have to see the results in the pitch, in the game, in normal game, you know. So we'll be good to see our level, and we'll be good to have new arrivals to go unit compact with the other guy, and that's it.
Yeah, very good. Okay, so just a little bit, I suppose, to let the fans know, you've played in Italy, you've played in Spain, you've played in Albania, and what made you want to come and play in Dundalk? What drew you to come and play in Ireland, in the League of Ireland here with Dundalk?
Was Filippo, of course, he know Italian leagues. So he asked for me, to my agent, and he explained to us this situation, this club. He spoke so good for the club, for the county too, and they achieved a good they did a good season last season. So I thought for me was a good opportunity to show my skills in a club as Dundalk, and I'm happy for this because I really trust the project, and I think we can achieve great results this year.
Okay, very good. And away from football, obviously we're in the middle of a pandemic. It's probably been hard for you to get to really know the Irish people too well. But how are you getting on away from football? You've settled in your new house in Cersei.
Yes, we hope this situation will finish so soon. But no, I went out a little bit in Dundalk. I saw the city, the town. I like this style. You know, you went in Italy, so you know we are used to big building, like a different kind of cities.
Yeah.
Yes, but I like this kind of style. So hopefully everything will be open soon, and I could see more, something more. I'm so curious to see more things in
to
town.
To explore the city, yeah. I understand.
Yeah, to explore, yes.
Yeah.
He's blown the whistle. It's all over. And Dundalk, for the first time in 6 years, the Opel League
of Ireland champions. It's that long ago, Taylor Chris were 12p, and the smell of Bovril and deep heat etched in my memory. O'Neill, Lawler, or Lawless, Malone and McHugh. Five-man defence you couldn't get through. Wise, Murray, Cleary, and the gent Barry Keogh. A midfield 10 times better than from St. Pat's in the Bows. Mary McGillicott shouting, "Come on, Dundalk!" Another goal from Desi Gorman, the Dundalk Hawk. Mean cry from Lily White. Me and mascot against Bray. As a child, my only ambition was to sign up and play. I wasn't good enough, though, but these lads were. Can you follow in the footsteps and be the next Dundalk star?
Premier Division League of Ireland titles.
12 FAI Cup.
Yeah, so Ali, tell us who you are, and just maybe give us a bit of background into who Ali Lalani is.
Sure, absolutely. Hi guys, my name is Ali Lalani, and I am the marketing director of BetRegal.com, the proud new sponsor of Dundalk FC, and for me anyway, a new fan of Dundalk FC. I am sitting in Toronto, Canada right now. I am a North American boy, a Toronto boy born and raised, but our ownership group has Irish roots, and therefore the Irish market was of particular interest to us. So we're very, very excited to be sponsoring Dundalk FC. Football/soccer, as we call it over here, is still a little bit new to me, and we're still learning the beautiful game, as it were. But we're excited to be on board with the Dundalk FC.
Yeah, thanks, Ali. And just tell us a little bit about BetRegal, kind of when it was formed. You know what you guys do. I know you said that there's some Irish roots, so maybe if you can tell us a little bit about that.
Absolutely. So we BetRegal.com was formed in 2015 with a focus on European key European markets. We always had a vision later on towards North American markets as well, as Canada regulates, especially where we will have a presence here. But we've defined Ireland as a market of focus for us based on historical performance. We've been mostly present in the UK, Germany, Norway, and Ireland, but we've seen a special affinity with our Irish customers. They seem to stick around with us long. We have a good product mix for the Irish customer, and they seem to see value with us. And we also create a lot of very customized promotions for the Irish market. Again, our ownership group has Irish roots, so it was very interested and invested in not only being a sponsor but also being a part of the community with Dundalk.
Yeah, very good, Ali. And in terms of what can the Dundalk FC supporters expect from the partnership? I know you touched a little bit about community and maybe giveaways and stuff like that. So I'm guessing you're thinking that, you know, BetRegal is more than just a sponsor.
Absolutely. Yeah, and that's an important part of what we're doing here, I think, is making sure that we're not a brand that wants to go out and sponsor 15 different teams and have logos on jerseys and not have the extent of our partnership. We've identified markets that we feel are important, both from a kind of a personal perspective as well as from a business perspective, and we really want to integrate with the Dundalk audience. A big part of that, look, we're, everybody in the world, including me in Toronto, Canada, is going through a tough time right now. It's, you know, some of us are in the lucky position where work hasn't been an issue. And we want to give back to those who are kind of in need right now. Look, sport is a way to distance yourself from some of the realities of life right now. And I think that's one way we can benefit in adding a product mix that's going to be exciting and engaging for the customer. But it goes deeper than that, I think. I think it's about, you know, integrating with the community and helping out where we can and understanding what the specific need of Dundalk is, and then doing what we can in support of our products. On the product side, we also want to be a kind of a member and an ambassador in the community for BetRegal.
Very good, Ali. And just kind of finally, you know, in terms of BetRegal's hope for the season, I know from, you know, with the Dundalk point of view, that will probably be trophies and European success. I mean, any particular BetRegal hopes for the season ahead?
Absolutely. Well, we consider BetRegal, we consider ourselves the best, right? We're a small up and coming brand, but we try and do things to the best of our ability. So it made sense to partner with someone we feel is the best in their market as well. So I would love to see a picture of a Dundalk championship trophy up on that wall, hopefully at the end of this year. I think we're going to gauge success. Look, I think ROI, we talk about ROI, can be defined in a few ways. So one way is integration in the community, but we also, again, want to make sure that we're doing our part to help out with people that are in need in Dundalk. So again, providing some fun, but also providing some help and making sure that we are an integrated sponsor in the Dundalk community and not just and not just a logo on a jersey.
Just wanted to come on quickly and let you know that we're still open, we're still in operation throughout this current lockdown, both in Blackrock and in Dundalk. We have delicious coffee and treats going every day, 7 days a week, from 8:30 to 5:00 in both hatches. And we also have a lovely breakfast and lunch menu available as well. So come on down, check it out, and get in touch, guys. On behalf of myself and all the team, we'd also like to wish Dundalk the very best of luck for the next season, and very good luck tonight as well. See you soon.
Connor here from XX Ice in Dundalk. We are the biggest roll ice cream company in Ireland. We specialise in roll ice cream, bubble waffles, milkshakes, sundaes and brownies. So we opened our first shop August 3rd, 2019, and it was small but it done the job. We realised that the demand was pretty high, so that's when we made the decision to move to a bigger location. Now we sit 33 people. We have a full delivery area out the back. We have social media room downstairs and two office spaces. So this really gives us the opportunity to expand in the future. And this year we are going to be moving outside of Loud, so the location will be announced soon. started doing deliveries last year during COVID, and that really took our business to the next level. We deliver to Dundalk and all surrounding areas, and you can order through our website, xxiice.com. So now I'm going to talk you through how to make our most popular rolled ice cream. Step 1, ice cream flavors. Step 2, our premium ice cream mix. Step 3, mix everything together. Step 4, spread into a rectangle and roll. Step 5, finish. Check us out on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok and YouTube at XXIice, where we have gained almost 500,000 followers.
Welcome back to Oriel Park for this second half of Dundalk against Bohemians in this pre-season match for 2021. We're just trying to get a handle on the substitutions at the break. Certainly we see that Peter Cherry has replaced Alessio Abibi in the Dundalk goal, and Sam Stanton has come into midfield. We'll get a handle on who he's replaced in just a moment. As regards Bohemians, I don't see any obvious changes just yet by Keith Long, but it'll be Bose to get us underway here for this second half. So a chance for Dundalk supporters, Stephanie, to get a look at Sam Stanton, new signing, Scottish player in midfield in the second half.
Yes, experienced player. He played at Hibs and Dundee, so he's got a bit of pedigree behind him. Obviously, I think he went to play in America, and with everything that happened with COVID, he had to come back to Scotland, and it's worked in favour for Dundalk because he's here to play for them. And as we said before, I think lots of forwards coming into Dundalk, but not many midfielders, and Stanton will be looking to try and stamp his authority on the team today.
Another player in for the second half is Junior on the right hand side. So a couple of changes by the Lily Whites at the start of the second half.
It's been a bit of a Hudson-Odoi moment, I think, with Perez going back off, was it? Perez has gone off for him, isn't it?
So Jesus Perez with a very short stint for Dundalk here this afternoon, replaced by Junior.
Yeah, it's expected in pre-season, is it? We're going to see a lot of changes throughout the game. I think you might even see players who have gone off come back on and stuff like that. So it will be interesting to see all these new signings and give them the opportunity to get in. It's a difficult one in pre-season when the team is chopping and changing all the time as well to get that rhythm going. But hopefully the game won't lose the little bit of flair and quality that it had got in the first half.
Here's Daniel Cleary. And I think Greg Sloggett is the other midfielder who has gone off to be replaced by Sam Stanton. So Sloggett makes way for the Edinburgh man. Here's Chris Shields now for Dundalk. Chris Shields once more. Drills in into the feet of Junior. Really good touch by the Englishman. Comes in as a replacement pretty much for the departing Stefan Cholovic, who never really happened for him at Dundalk. There's another cross in from that left-hand side, Dave McMillan. And it's laid off by Junior. Shot by Stanton. He's blocked by Keith Buckley. And maybe Bastien Arie can lead the charge here for Bohemians into the Dundalk half. Sonny Nattestad getting out in front of Alua. But Bohemians hold on to the possession through Liam Burt. Here's Arie again. Arie will turn away from Chris Shields. And use Ali Coote. Now Wilson. Kelly. Buckley with the layoff to Rob Cornwall. Buckley again. Here's Bastien Arie. Some space ahead of him. Only too happy to eat it up and find Thomas Alua. Arie with the shot. Blocked by Stanton. And the cross coming in. And it's a wayward one.
Yeah,
from
I think
that right hand side.
You can see Chris Shields there trying to have a chat with him, I think, a little bit. Unorganised at the minute with those couple of changes coming in. I think Stanton needs to get to grips and just get his positioning right. There's a couple of gaps coming up in midfield there, which Chris Shields wasn't happy about. But as I said, changes in the game, it's going to take a couple of minutes for these players to kind of adjust to the system and get themselves in. But they don't want to be leaving gaps in midfield for Bowes to play through.
Sam Stanton with that layoff. It's an area of the pitch where I do feel Dundalk needed to strengthen in the close season in midfield, and I think a lot will rest on Sam Stanton and how successful he is here.
Yeah, definitely. I think there'll be a bit of pressure on him. A lot of talk about the midfield last season and maybe lacking that little bit of pace. It'll be interesting to see what he offers in midfield. I think, as we said before, Chris Shields has been excellent throughout the seasons, but it's more so that attacking midfield player. And that the transition to defend, I think maybe it struggled a little bit last season with when they lost the ball high up the pitch, they have the pace to get back in and defend, you know. So it would be interesting to see how Stanton gets on.
Of course, many people would say that the Shamrock Rovers midfield perhaps edged Dundalk's last season. I'm sure Chris Shields and Greg Sloggart would disagree with that, but of course, they've lost two very pivotal players, Shamrock Rovers, this season. Two players are very difficult to replace in Jack Byrne and Aaron McInniff.
Yeah, exactly. I think particularly Jack Byrne, obviously his rise over the last couple of seasons and getting into the Irish squad. I think there was a lot of people crying out for him to get into that squad and be given the opportunity to play. So losing those two players, as you mentioned, will be a big loss for Rovers. Rovers obviously have brought in their own players, a couple of players from here too, gone in there. So, look, it's a big shake-up within the league, all the teams making changes, and it makes for an exciting season ahead, as I mentioned before, just to see all these new players and how they settle into their new clubs.
And Daniel McDonald in the Independent yesterday had the news that Richie Towell looks likely to arrive at Tala in the middle of the season in July.
Yeah.
So that'll certainly strengthen their ranks.
He's looking to see his season in Salford, I think, isn't he? Looks, obviously, Richie Towell showed the quality that he had when he played in the league previously. Be a great signer for them, obviously. Not what Dundalk fans want to see, but good for the league all around, I think, to have quality players like Richie Towell coming back into the league.
Thomas Alua with the shot. Sonny Nattestad out with the brave block for Dundalk. Play continues. Nattestad has stayed down. And Junior helping out defensively. And there's a wild enough kick at him by Keith Ward. Not very friendly. Junior, though, carries on and finds David McMillan. Rob Cornwall out to attempt to hold him up, and he's done well, Rob Cornwall. He's defended that situation well.
Yeah, it's good from Junior, isn't it? I think a few of the players, I think Tyreek Wilson had a little bit of a swipe at him as well, but he's done well to avoid it and get forward. But good play, good positive play from Junior coming on in this
and
second
Cleary
half.
Appealing for the free kick earlier in that breakaway that he felt Dundalk should have had. James Talbot now. Really good rise by Liam Burt to get up ahead of Cameron Dummigan for the flick on. No one in a white shirt in behind though. Here's Nattestad. What have you made of his performance in the, what have we had, 51 minutes so far?
Yeah, he's been comfortable enough in possession, hasn't he? Probably hasn't been tested too much with players getting at him and down the sides of him, which I think will probably be where Bowes will be looking to do. I think obviously you can see the presence, the physical presence that he has there, but he hasn't really been tested for his pace just yet, so it'll be interesting to see if what he's like in when the ball is played in behind. But so far, so good. As we said before, his height and his aerial presence within that defence is something that Dundalk will be looking to use, not just on defending set pieces, but also on attacking set pieces. But he showed sparks of what he can be. And as I said, he hasn't yet been tested down the wings, which is probably something that I'd like to see, just to see where he's at. But so far, so good.
Yeah, people often think a tall player like that, he's going to be uncomfortable with the ball on his feet. But he hasn't looked uncomfortable in what we've seen so far.
No, not at all. I'm a tall player and I'm good with the ball at my feet, I think. So I'll speak for the tall people here and say that he's done quite well with the ball at his feet, as you mentioned, and he's comfortable in possession.
That's a good ball through for Ali Coote, but the dog defended well. Wilson for Bastianeri here.
I might mention I'm not quite as tall as Sonny, but... I don't think many are.
Here's Rob Cornwall. Andy Lyons. Ari. Stanton wins that back well for Dundalk. Here's McMillan. O'Kane holds it up and finds Cameron Domigan. Chris Shields has spotted the player in space on this right-hand side. In Yorkovskis. Now Cleary. Now Shields again. Bit of purpose about this Dundalk attack. Here comes the cross from Yorkovskis. Really good ball. Oh, what an equaliser that is by Dundalk. Absolutely superb. Yorkovskis with the cross in. David McMillan, I think it was, with the finish. And Dundalk have levelled it.
Really, really good play. High up the pitch. You can see Dan Cleary getting up high as well, but supporting that play. But what a ball in it is. From Yorkovskis. And as you said, it's good to see two players running. A junior almost gets to it, and you've got McMillan backing him up. And that's... For any management to see, that's great commitment to try and get into the box and throw yourself at a ball, but it's a great finish and well controlled into the back of the net from McMillan.
And we said it in the first half with that McMillan effort, that acrobatic effort in the first half, that he scores such a variety of goals, and that was totally apart from that effort and totally apart from his goals in the FAI Cup final. That was a poacher's goal.
Exactly, and he scores all types of goals, and I think he's been really good today as well. His link-up play has been good, he's been clever. At times when you thought maybe he'll turn and shoot, he's set it off. He's made the right decisions at all the right times, you know, and he deserved that goal. It's a great finish coming at the back post, but it's all about that crossing. I think the pace on that ball makes it easy for the striker. Well, not easy, but it makes his job a little bit easier just to get a touch on it. But really, really good finish. And as I said, he's been excellent today so far.
Yorkovskis with that delivery from the right-hand side, and it invited a player onto it. And David McMillan was that player. And Dundalk have levelled it up here. And it's just about no more than they deserve, I think, 1-1. Based on what we've seen here, probably the right result. If it stays that way, certainly it's the right result at this stage of the game. Here's Thomas Alua on the Dundalk right-hand side, the Bohemians left, and he's done well to win a corner kick here for Bowes.
Yeah, the game has opened right up, hasn't it? It's good to see. I think both teams maybe have not been as cautious as they were maybe in the first half, so we'll see the game open up a little bit more.
Dundalk preparing a couple of substitutions as Bowes prepare to take this corner kick. It's Liam Burt now. It'll be a right-footed in-swinger from Burt. And it's to Kieran Kelly, the intended target. And Kelly manages to get the header away, but can't keep it down and can't control it.
Yeah, it's not too dissimilar to Dundalk in the second half. Our first half just a little bit behind them, but done well to get a little bit of contact on it.
Chris Shields now. Domigan in onto that right foot and in towards McMillan with the flick on. Junior with the control. Can he tee up Stanton? Just doesn't quite get it right. Just Bowes get it away.
Just can't get it out of his feet, can he? Just in the build-up, interesting play, the build-up to that as well. Young O'Kane coming inside to create that space, and Lyons followed him inside, and that space in behind the fullback was on. So it's a clever run by Lyons, or by O'Kane, should I say, to create that space for his fullback getting beyond them.
Dundalk free kick. Kieran Kelly, the offender. And here's a double substitution for Dundalk. And this is where we rely on the stadium announcer, Michael Duffy, to let us know just who's coming on. Sonny Nattestad, certainly, and Cameron Domigan, the players going off. Number 11, Patrick McElhaney, and number 15, Gary Lee. So Patrick McElhaney making way. And Dara Lee, two players that are recognisable enough. So Sonny Nattestad going off Dara Leahy into the game. And Cameron Domigan making away for Patrick McElhaney. So that will probably necessitate a change in system of some kind for Dundalk. It appears Chris Shields has gone in at centre back, in the centre of that back three.
Yeah, there'll be a little bit of a shuffle around here, aren't you? But we're not too unfamiliar with Leahy and McElhaney coming in here. So two players that we know a lot about from last season, particularly Leahy. I think he's come in at left back since Dave Massey got injured and really, really cemented that place in the team.
Leahy out onto that left wing back role, and Patrick McElhaney into centre midfield alongside Sam Stanton.
It's a different mix of players, isn't it? As we said, it's what pre-season's all about. It's trying to see where your players fit, who gels well together. So it's an opportunity for these players coming in to try and gel with those new players that have signed.
It's been a valuable exercise by Dundalk and Bohemians here this afternoon. Decent quality game. Here's Patrick McElhaney. Now Dan Cleary fizzes it into the feet of Stanton. Can't quite control it. Ere capitalises. Here's Wilson. Now Talbot. Well, Kieran Kelly just asked a little bit of Tyreek Wilson there with that ball. Put plenty of pace on it and forced him to have to really concentrate on controlling it, and it allowed Junior in to make things difficult, and Dundalk have a throw in. Rivas Jurkowskis, in the absence of ball boys, as is the situation at the moment, has to retrieve that ball himself. Patrick McElhaney, as ever, willing to take possession, but they've given it away here, Dundalk. Here's a Lua to Ere. Now Wilson, forward at pace. Keith Ward. Ward has spotted Andy Lyons in space on the opposite side. Now Keith Buckley. Coote. And now Kelly. Wilson to Ward, lovely back heel, clever play by Ward. Bastianeri being shadowed by Patrick McElhaney. Both players have left their midfield spots to, well, in Ari's case, to try and find space on the left hand side, and Patrick McElhaney to stay with him. Rob Cornwall, well, he was tempted to have a shot, the pitch opened up, and Keith Buckley, he'll not thank him for that. Good sliding challenge by Dara Leahy to win that back for Dundalk. Shields, clever by Shields, really good. Now McElhaney, Ere just gets a toe poke on it, but Dundalk hold on to the possession.
Yeah, it's similar to what happened at half time. A lot of changes coming in, a little bit of reshuffling. I think you can see Chris Shields has stepped back into that midfield role. I think Leahy is getting forward quite a bit, but he's part of that back three alongside Jurkowskis on this side. They kind of tuck in together to cover each other. So
Leahy's ball in, almost found Sam Stanton. Wilson for Buckley now. And now Alua might try and test Andy Boyle here. Keith Ward making ground through the middle. Alua, well, the assistant on the far side, I think, has decided that he's fouled Andy Boyle there.
I think something that Dundalk fans would like to see is the recovery run there from Jurkowskis. He made up a lot of ground to get back and just make sure that he didn't give the boss, Ward, I think it was, who was up with him, given the time and space to run into. He worked his socks off to get back and cover. And that's kind of the way you have to play when you're playing like Dundalk, and you're playing this kind of formation where it gives you the freedom to get forward. You have to be able to make those recovery runs, and it's good to see the fitness is there for him as well this early in pre-season.
Daniel Cleary, Junior. Wilson's header. Didn't really get the purchase on he wanted. And Junior emerges with the ball and has won another free kick. He seems to be a bit of a magnet for free kicks, Junior.
Yeah, he's a tricky player, isn't he? I think he's a defender's worst nightmare because you don't know what he's going to do, and he can go by you with ease, and he's probably going to be one of those players who does draw in a lot of fouls.
Patrick McElhaney over the set piece net. Andy Boyle and Dan Cleary adding their presence inside the Bohemians penalty area. Ryan O'Kane over this one too, but I suspect it'll be the left boot of McElhaney. It won't. O'Kane confidently right-footed in, and there's an appeal for handball against Andy Lyons by everybody in and around the ball inside the penalty area.
He looks a little bit suspicious himself, doesn't he? It's a difficult one, I think, coming across. Maybe if he had VAR, we might have got a decision, but it'd be a harsh one. I think he didn't put his hand out, his hands down by his side, and it's cleared for a corner.
Ryan O'Kane with this corner kick now. Left arm raised in the air, it's to the front post to David McMillan. Ari just does enough. O'Kane, pass Ari. He'll have enjoyed that. And he's won another corner kick here, Ryan O'Kane.
Yeah, it seems to be the corner of choice, isn't it? That front post ball, and maybe distracting the both defenders with your height that you have in the back post, and it creates that space for McMillan to run into on the front post.
Another corner kick from the youngster, and it's another good delivery. Thomas Alua with the glancing header away and gets decent distance on it. Liam Burt with the last touch. Dara Leahy with the throw-in. McElhaney ambles across. And first time finds Andy Boyle now. It's an up and under. Rob Cornwall favourite to win that over Junior, and he does. Here's Alua. Alua just... Chris Shields just bounces off him, and Alua brings the ball away. And running at Andy Boyle. Ball's going to break here for Ali Coote.
It's good strength from Alua, isn't it? You don't see many people pushing Chris Shields off the ball like that. He's done well to keep possession for his team.
Even from this vantage point, it's very evident Alua has good upper body strength, doesn't he?
Yeah, it's quite to see. He's quite a big guy. He's strong. He's centre forward. And as we said before the game, I think Bows like to play at direct football and look for that centre forward when they can, so he's a player who I'm sure they'll look to a lot this season.
Bohemians with another friendly today, incidentally, against UCD, Stephanie, and it's a testament to the size of their squad, isn't it, that they can feel a pretty decent team here today and will do another one presumably against UCD.
Yeah, exactly, and it's a strange one because in pre-season, as we mentioned, you see Dundalk making so many changes and they have the fresh legs coming in, but it does shake up the team a bit, so that can kind of, I suppose, take the momentum out of performance, whereas Bows have the freedom to kind of play that 90 minutes and they may get tired, but they still have the kind of structure within their team with less changes being made. So it's a strange one. I haven't really heard many teams playing two friendlies in one day, but as you say, it shows how big a squad they have, and to be able to get two friendlies in one day is great for the squad to get as many minutes under their belt as possible.
We mentioned in the first half Georgie Kelly, who's now a Bohemians player. Another very good acquisition in the close season, Stephen Mallon, who was with Derry City last season. An exciting player, ex-Sheffield United. And scored a really good goal against Bohemians last season, a solo goal.
Yeah, a winger coming in as well. You mentioned before, Danny Grant's excellent last season for Bowes. Probably one of the players of the season, in my opinion. And they've brought in Mallon to try and maybe replace him and get him into the team in those wide areas. So another exciting prospect going into the season for Bowes fans to look forward to.
Here's Keith Buckley, who's sizing up a shot, but Peter Cherry right in the direct line of the ball and saves it comfortably. It's shaping up, Stephanie, when you look at the acquisitions that clubs have made. You know, it's an exciting time in the league, isn't it? A lot of international players coming into the league. It could be a very good league season. If we can get fans back into the grounds in the second half, we could have a great climax.
Exactly, and I think even going forward with the games being streamed, obviously today we're doing one ourselves, but to have fans around the world looking in on the League of Ireland can only be good for it. It only promotes the league itself and even the players playing in the league. You know, I think this league has grown over the last number of years and we've had some very good quality players leave the league to go to England and go elsewhere, but to see players wanting to come and play in the League of Ireland is good to see, and I think it can only be a positive thing and long may it continue.
Here's Dara Leahy now. Andy Boyle. He does look more comfortable and more accomplished in the number 4 shirt rather than the 44. I don't care what anyone says. It's Dundalk still with the possession. Patrick McElhaney, and he's spotted Talbot off his line, perhaps.
It's ambitious, isn't it? I have to admire it, all the vision and to see it and to actually go for it. I think this early in pre-season, I'd be more watching my legs in the game and trying to keep myself running than trying things like that. But good to see McElhaney spotting the opportunity to try and chip Talbot and go.
Let's hope for an injury-free 2021 for Patrick McElhaney. His 2020 was somewhat injury interrupted, but he was fortunate enough to play in many of the pivotal and the big matches last season. But he's one of the the league's outstanding lights, isn't he, when he's on his game?
Yeah, he is. And as you mentioned, he was lucky enough to be involved in some of the bigger games, but he's a player. No one likes to see a player being injured and not getting that opportunity to get a run of games together. I've been there myself in the past, so hopefully, as you mentioned, he can get through this pre-season and get a good, strong pre-season under his belt, and we'll see a good season from Patrick McElhenney.
Junior has just run into Keith Ward and has come off the worst for the challenge. Seems to be some sort of a slight injury. I don't think it's anything that's going to force him off to his left ankle.
Yeah, I think it's just a sore one, isn't it? It's that initial bang that you get, but you'll run it off. I think he looks okay. It's nothing too serious, thankfully.
And he's fit enough to take the throw in himself, so throws it back to the Bows goalkeeper. Here's Rob Cornwall now. Ali Coote almost has his pocket picked by Patrick McElhenney. And there's a sliced clearance by James Talbot. And Junior uses Jorkowskis, architect of the Dundalk goal, the equaliser. Here's Junior now, edge of the penalty area. Might tee up McElhenney. Just couldn't quite get it out of his feet quick enough. He still has it though, McElhenney. Looking for space. Forced backwards. Stanton. And well, he'll want to forget about that one.
Yeah, it was well worked initially though, wasn't it? With Junior coming inside and getting that pass in. And maybe just a little bit too much on the setback for McElhenney to get the shot off first time. He had to take a touch and it gave the Bows defenders a chance to get back and defend. But good play, well worked. And they are patient as well, not to, apart from Stanton obviously blasting over the bar, but they were patient to get that chance.
James Talbot's clearance, Darragh Leahy's header, Sam Stanton conceding the throw in. We're going to have another Dundalk change here in a moment. And I think it's Ryan O'Kane who'll make way.
Really impressive performance from him today, I think, Ryan O'Kane.
Val Adedekun, the 18-year-old into the game, to replace a 17-year-old. And Ryan O'Kane, I think, can be very happy with his contribution today.
Yeah, excellent. Really, really good player. Really very, very showed what he was about. And as I said, I was impressed with not just his movement on the ball, but the runs that he made off the ball were intelligent to create space for other players as well. But yeah, he should be very happy and very proud of himself today. Good performance.
A very proud young man, I imagine. A very proud family and a very proud football club in Balorgan United, who led his development. Well done to everybody there. Let's hope that Ryan O'Kane is a name that we hear during the season. Here's Kieran Kelly now. Ali Coote, or Andy Lyons rather, doesn't manage to keep that in play. The throw in is Dundalk's. Plenty of messages coming in on Twitter. Everybody seems to be enjoying the coverage of the match, which is good news. Keith Buckley to Thomas Alua.
Yeah, I think everybody's just happy to see football back, isn't it? It's the League of Ireland coming back is exciting for the Irish fans. Unfortunately, they can't be here, but for them to be able to watch it through the live stream is nice. And as I said, having the football to watch is nice in this day and age with everything that's going on.
Jorkowskis to McElhenney. McElhenney, and he spotted the run of Adedekun here, and he's managed to control it. And he's reversed that into the penalty area. Darragh Leahy looking to challenge. And, well, there was appeals from the Bohemians supporters for a free kick for the push by Darragh Leahy. I think it was the faintest of pushes in fairness, but they get the benefit of the referee's whistle.
Yeah, it was a good run by the young player just coming on there. And maybe, don't know if he meant to do what he done. I think he's trying to loft it over the keeper's head, but got a little bit too much on it. But good run and just unfortunate with the finish.
Young Val Adedekun signed his first professional contract with the club last month, having come through the academy teams. He has made a first team appearance against Shamrock Rovers when he came off the bench in the league fixture back in September.
It's good to see the young players getting an opportunity, as you say, coming up the ranks and getting to play in the senior football and work their way through and be given the opportunity when they do get there. So it's nice to see young players like himself and O'Kane coming on and showing what they can do.
Andy Lyons himself, a young player, taking this throw in, just 20 years of age. There were fears that he might head across the channel in the close season. Good cross in, and that's going to fall here for Keith Ward, and he's fluffed his lines, Keith Ward, somewhat. That was an opportunity. He could see the whites of Peter Cherry's eyes, but just gets it wrong.
Yeah, he's run off him there, hasn't he? He was left in space and he just didn't catch it. I think he maybe took his eye off the ball, but we don't want to be seeing a Bows player with that much space within their box. I'm sure Peter Cherry won't be happy with his defending there. But
well, Keith Ward had the opportunity to score against his old club. Scored what might have been an important goal in Europe last season against Ferrovar in the Europa League first qualifying round. Sadly, it wasn't enough to see Bows go through, and they dropped out of the competition on penalties.
Yeah,
they get another crack at it this year, of course.
Yeah, Ward's been around the league a long time, hasn't he? Very, very creative player, neat and tidy. He's been very good today as well. He's shown his dominance at times and getting on the ball in good positions.
Here's Keith Buckley. Now Kieran Kelly. Buckley once more. It's a loose enough pass, but Ali Coote will be favoured to make it. Now Cornwall. Bursts between two Dundalk players into midfield, but Adetta Kuhn is there to interrupt any progress. James Talbot. Kieran Kelly. Now Erie again, and that's a nice touch by Erie to Keith Ward, and he was looking for Alua first time, but a good interception by Andy Boyle. Dara Leahy, Patrick McElhaney after it. Andy Lyons is there, but he's gifted it to McElhaney. Well, it's McMillan, and now it's McElhaney. And that's a good save by James Talbot.
Very good save by Talbot. Really, really quick off the mark to come out. And good play between McMillan and McElhaney. But yeah, really, really quick, decisive goalkeeping from Talbot there.
Just for a second, it appeared there was a little bit of confusion between McElhaney and McMillan, just exactly who was going to take it on. And it gave Talbot the opportunity, didn't it, to come out and block?
That split second, I think, maybe gave him the opportunity to close the space. But good play nonetheless from both of them. They worked it out and managed to get that shot off, but just a really good save in the end.
Here's McElhaney again. Now Junior. Jurkowskis as ever on the outside. Well, just not perfect for Jurkowskis by Junior. He just accelerated and Junior hadn't taken that fact into account as he played the ball, and now Bohemians bring it away. Tyreek Wilson, Alua trying to stay onside ahead of him. All Wilson can do is squirt it into midfield, but Bows hold on to the possession. Here's Keith Buckley. Bastien Array finds a little bit of space outside the Dundalk penalty area and looks to just engineer a pass into Alua. It doesn't quite come off.
Yeah, Peter Cherry comes out and collects us. Not too dissimilar to Talbot. He's on his toes and he's ready to spot any danger, and he comes out and clears and collects the ball and stops the danger in his tracks.
Here's Daniel Cleary now. McElhaney put under pressure by Buckley. Cornwall. Keith Ward looking to lurk and slip in behind Jurkowskis, but his header finds Cleary. Now Cherry, long hopeful one forward, but Andy Lyons should be favoured here. Junior applying the pressure. And Dara Leahy has his pocket picked. Here's Liam Burt, but a good sliding challenge by Chris Shields retrieves the ball for the Lily Whites. Daniel Cleary. Now Chris Shields again. Just under 15 minutes left of the 90. Sam Stanton to Dara Leahy. Leahy's cross in. Oh, and there's a goal. It's Val Adetta Kuhn with the finish. And he's struck it past James Talbot. Simple enough opportunity, but well worked by Dundalk down the left-hand side.
Yeah, it's a good ball in by Leahy, isn't it? He's worked hard to get down the pitch and puts it. It gets a good ball across the 6-yard box. Sorry, I didn't want to be on over the announcer there. but yeah, well worked goal. Last few minutes of the game, still have that quality and still have that high tempo to get up the pitch, which is good to see from Dundalk. But really good finish and really good cross.
So 1-1, the scoreline at Oriel Park. And indeed, I think it may well have was a Junior with the finish.
It was Junior
yeah. With the finish. And 1-1 at Oriel Park. James Talbot beaten twice now in the second half.
I think we mentioned before, pre-season is about getting your minutes up, getting a good bit of match sharpness, but I think in the back of every player's mind, you always want to win a game of football, so I think that'll be good for Dundalk's confidence to get that second goal, and Bowes will be also looking to try and get back in and maybe get an equaliser going forward. As I said, no footballer wants to lose a match at what stage it is of the season.
Here's Dara Leahy, first touch for Odedeku. Leahy gets it back. Now Patrick McElhaney. McElhaney with the shot from some distance straight at James Talbot. But he's certainly capable from that sort of range.
I think perhaps maybe the substitutes for Dundalk and the extra bit of energy that they've been able to bring on, I think you can start to see Bowes possibly getting a little bit tired in the latter stages of this game, which is obviously expected at this stage of pre-season. As I mentioned, they have another game later on today, so maybe haven't had the opportunity to make as many changes as Dundalk have over the last 70 or so minutes.
So Dundalk trailed on 33 minutes. Liam Burt with the game's opening goal after an error in midfield. Dave McMillan levelling things up on 53. And then just a moment ago, Junior on 76. Making it 2-1. David McMillan making way for Jesus Perez, who comes back in for Dundalk. Keith Ward going off for Bowes too. And Brad Rolt, another of those new signings for Bowes. He's a forward, 17-year-old striker, has joined on loan from Peterborough until the summer, with a view to potentially extending his deal until the season's end. He replaces Keith Ward. Dundalk with another player warming up away to our right-hand side. So I doubt we're finished with the substitutions just yet. Here's Andy Lyons now with the throw-in. 2-1 to Dundalk. It's been an entertaining enough pre-season match. Can Bowes create a leveller here? Liam Burke trying to make something happen. The clearance away crashes off his head. And he's felt that, Burt. He stayed down inside the penalty areas. Dundalk looked to break away through Sam Stanton.
Yeah, it's a head injury, isn't it? Just make sure the player's okay, first and foremost. You spoke about Bowes, maybe lack of changes. I think Ward going off there and Rolt coming on. A player who's been on loan at a couple of clubs in the National League in England and obviously wanted to come over to play in Bowes and get some first-team experience, which you'd like to see from a young player. He wants to get game time, but Keith Long spoke highly of him, so it'll be interesting to see now what he can do in these last few minutes.
And, well, Liam Burt has stayed down here. It was entirely accidental. It was a clearance of the ball that struck Burt full on the back of the head from close range too. So it will have hurt.
I'd say he just needs a second just to get his bearings back in. It's not nice to get the ball in the head like that. So hopefully he'll be okay and be able to continue. But as I said, the most important thing is to check the player's safety, particularly with a head injury.
As we head for 10 minutes or so to go in this match here at Oriel Park. And it's been an enjoyable game, Stephanie.
Yeah, it has. And as I said before, it's been a game full of a bit of everything, quite a bit of quality. As I said, for this stage of pre-season, you expect players to maybe not have that match sharpness, but a lot of players have shown good spells and look to try and get on the ball and play. And I think it opened up the more the game went on as well, which is good to see. And always nice to get good goals in pre-season, as we said. But yeah, really overall good game so far. Last 10 minutes coming up, I'd say a lot of tired legs out there, particularly Dundalk. It's their first game of the season, or first game of pre-season, should I say. So yeah, really good game for the first one out for Dundalk. And obviously Bowes in their second one today, or second one of pre-season game so far.
And Bohemians are going to take no chances with Liam Burt. They will make a change. 14, Robbie Mahan, a young left winger, will come into the game to replace Liam Burt. And I think we saw signs in the match that Liam Burt might be an asset here for Bowes this season.
Yeah, definitely. We spoke about him in the first half. He probably had to do a little bit more of his defensive duties alongside Andy Lyons there in the right-hand side. Dunmaghan and O'Kane had them under a little bit of pressure, but he showed his quality with the finish for the goal. Obviously, maybe a misplaced pass from Sloga gave him the advantage to get in there, but he showed the composure to finish well, and as you say, he showed moments of good quality on the ball and what maybe he will offer for Bowes this season.
It's Bohemians with the possession here. Kieran Kelly for Rob Cornwall. Cornwall again now under pressure from Perez. Dan Cleary allows that ball to beat him. Here's Perez. Now Stanton shapes up the shot and just lifts it a yard over James Talbot's crossbar.
You can't blame him this stage of the game to want to get a shot off on goal. It's just a little bit too high over the goal.
He's getting closer though. Here's James Talbot now. Darrelly beaten in the air there by young Robbie Mahan. Bastianeri maybe hasn't quite affected the game as much as he would have liked, but again, it's pre-season. It's a good run out. An opportunity to play your way into the season. Find that all-important match sharpness. Keith Buckley giving that away to Dundalk. What have you made of Rivas Jurkowskis, the Dundalk right-sided player?
Yeah, very good. I think he's shown he's very good getting forward. As I said before, it's nice to see him working hard to get back and defend when needed as well. I think he showed some good desire to get back in there and help his defence out at times. But going forward, he's been excellent. I think he's had a good first 90 minutes. He's played a lot of football here today. Obviously, first game of pre-season, but I've been impressed by him. I think he's shown moments of really good quality, and as I said, the work rate off the ball has been excellent as well.
Kieran Kelly with the slice forces Tyreek Wilson into some defending. Dan Cleary, two players in white shirts around him, he's done well to give Rolt the slip. Here's Andy Boyle, and most of the pace that we've seen in the game has gone out of it, I think, in the last 5 or 10 minutes here.
Yeah, it's to be expected, isn't it, as we said before. Couple of changes in the game, some tired bodies in that Bowes team with a lot of them playing the full 90 as well, so it's to be expected at this stage of pre-season, players to be tired and feeling it in their legs this last few minutes of the game.
Peter Cherry, he's given that away. Here's Mahan. Andy Lyons might take over here into the penalty area. Good run this by Lyons. And the cutback was looking for Alua inside the 6-yard box. It was cut out by Andy Boyle.
Yeah, it's a positive play from Andy Boyle and getting up the pitch. As we said, we just mentioned how tired players can be, and he's done well to get forward there and get that cross. And they've won a corner for their team here, looking to try and get push for that equaliser.
It was good news for Bohemians that Andy Lyons elected to stay for another season with the club. He's really made that right full-back berth his own. Here comes the corner kick now. And Peter Cherry punches that away. Ali Kutas after it. Now Wilson. James Talbot calling for it on the edge of his penalty area. Wilson obliges. And here's Wilson again. Tyreek Wilson actually scored a superb free kick against Bohemians in a 2-0 Waterford win last season. Ex-Manchester City player. Andy Lyons now with the throw-in. Keith Buckley aware of Kieran Kelly's positioning. He can play that blindly. Kelly has put Wilson under pressure again here from Junior. And that'll be a free kick. Tyreek Wilson disputing the decision.
Hello, I didn't look happy with that, did he? I think he's...
Friendly? What friendly? Talk about to make another change. And it looks like it's Jurkowskis.
Yeah, I think I spoke too soon about saying he got the 90 minutes. I thought maybe that was the end of the substitutes, but he's got a good 85 minutes or so in. But yeah, a really good performance from himself today.
So it's the number 18, Maioa, the player who replaces Jurkowskis, another academy player. Maioa, chance for him. And he's got a couple of early, nice, easy touches to play his way into the game. Dan Cleary, now Andy Boyle. I'm sure Maioa would like another one, and he gets it from Andy Boyle.
I think Andy Boyle's been very good today, very calm and reassured on the ball. Himself and Dan Cleary really starting the attacks at times for Dundalk, but they've both been very good today.
Here's Patrick McElhaney. Daniel Cleary. Cleary looking for the run of Perez. Perez for Dara Leahy. Leahy for Perez again. It'll be a throw-in. The referee has decided that it'll be the visitors who'll benefit from that. In the dying minutes of this pre-season match at Oriel Park, Dundalk leading by 2-1 here. Burt for Bowes in the first half, McMillan and Junior for Dundalk in the second. Andy Boyle with the clearance over the sideline, throw into Bohemians. Eri, good control under pressure, and does well to hold on to the ball. And find Cornwall and he gets it back. Andy Lyons now, first time, Rolt won't make that one. Cleary is there first. Tyreek Wilson, now Coote, playing in midfield this afternoon, but has operated out wide, certainly for Waterford last season, on a number of occasions when I saw them play against Dundalk. So, a bit of versatility acquired by Keith Long in Ali Coote. Here's Thomas Alua. Alua's cross in, not really dealt with very convincingly. Andy Lyons back in, no one there really in a white shirt. Andy Boyle just allows that ball run across his body, and Maioa will clear that away. Kieran Kelly. Cornwall for Wilson. Coote again. Andy Lyons. We are inside the final minute of the 90. Who's impressed you today, Stephanie? Anyone in particular you choose as the man of the match?
It's a typical one. I think for me personally, it'd be between McMillan and O'Kane. I think both of them seem to have quite a bit of influence on the game. Obviously, both of them on for a little bit longer period as well. But overall, I think Dundalk and Bowes would be happy with the performance today. I think it's a good run out for both teams. Two high-quality teams battling it out in early in pre-season. So a good run out for both teams today, I think.
And that is the final action of the game. And Stephanie will just slip downstairs and pick up one of the Dundalk players for a chat at full time. But final scoreline here, it's finished. Dundalk 2, Bohemians 1. The opening goal of the game, Liam Burt with it on 33 minutes. A mistake really in midfield by Dundalk offering the opportunity. Pitch really opened up for him and he was only too happy to attack the penalty area and drill a shot past Alessio Abebe to give Bohemians the opening goal of the game. Dundalk had to wait until 53 minutes for the equaliser. David McMillan, who'd had an excellent acrobatic effort, touched onto the crossbar by James Talbot in the first half. He obliged with the equalising goal on 53. A superb cross from the right-hand side. Rivas Jurkowskis with the delivery in. It deserved a goal and it got a goal. And David McMillan slides in to make it 1-1. And then on 76, Junior putting Dundalk in front for the first time in the match. 2-1, cross from the left-hand side on this occasion. Dara Leahy with the delivery in, and only too happy to finish it off for his first goal in a Dundalk shirt. was Junior, the ex-Derry City and Sligo Rovers player. How much will we see from him in the coming season? So many players made their debuts. I know it's not a competitive debut here this afternoon, but a debut nevertheless of a kind, and acquitted themselves pretty well, I think you'd have to say. Alessio Abebe dealt with whatever he had to deal with in that first half particularly well. Sonny Natastat too, Rivas Jurkovskis as well. Sam Stanton in the second half, maybe not as influential as we expect he will be, and then Junior with that goal in the second half to give Dundalk the win here. Not as convincing a win as when they met last time in a pre-season friendly. That was 4-1 back in July. And certainly not as convincing as in the FAI Cup quarter-final last season when Dundalk won by 4-1 as well. One of Dundalk's best performances of the season. Interesting, actually, last season, both of these clubs had one of their best performances against the other in the league. Bohemians winning 2-1 at Dalymount Park. An excellent performance that day. Danny Grant and Chris Twardek in particular, an excellent form for Bose on that occasion. And then, of course, 4-1 to Dundalk in that excellent FAI Cup quarter-final win at Dalymount Park. I do think that we may well have Stephanie ready, and David McMillan is alongside her. We're going to have a chat with her in just a moment. Stephanie is all lined up, and we'll cross across for a quick interview with Stephanie and David McMillan.
Hello, I'm joined here by David McMillan, Dundalk striker. David, nice to get off the mark today with the goal, but also to get the minutes under your belt, I'm sure.
Yeah, of course. The main thing for everybody is just their fitness at this stage, but we wanted to try and win the game as well and lay down a little marker, and thankfully we were able to do that today.
Yeah, and how did you find gelling with the new players? A lot of new forwards coming in there to play around you. Is there anybody you felt you gelled with a little bit more than the other, or did you feel good game to get to know the players, players?
I think we've done a lot of work in training just around our shape and how we want to try and play, and no, it was good. Look, there's four different players sort of playing around me today, and we're all getting to know each other. But I think there's a lot of good talent there. You know, young Ryan O'Kane has come in, he's brilliant for a 17-year-old, the skill he's got, and all the other lads, Junior, Ollie, all doing brilliant jobs. So I think we've plenty of good options there, and, you know, plenty of others to come back, like Pat Hoban and things as well. So I think in that area we're looking very strong.
Yeah, it's great to see. We spoke about it in commentary, an embarrassment of talent really with the players you have coming in there, but nice to get off the mark with the goal as well today.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I felt good in training. I've thankfully been fit and able to take part in every session, so it's good to get off the mark and get confidence going and feeling good going into, you know, our friendly next week again before the President's Cup.
Yeah, as you say, first game of pre-season, all about getting minutes and getting the team gelling well together. But it was a really, really good performance today from the team and from yourself. So thanks very much for joining me, David McMillan. Thank you.
Cheers, thanks, Steph.
Now we'll bring Adrian back in here alongside me.
Well, Stephanie, I think we both enjoyed that game this afternoon.
Yeah, really. We spoke about it in commentary. A lot of quality, as you said before. I think pre-season games, you maybe expect players to tire a little bit, but it didn't really happen until maybe the last 10 minutes of the game. So it was good, high-quality action for the viewers at home and for us here up in the gantry. It was a great game to be involved in.
Dundalk supporters watching in, of course they can't be here, but will they have been encouraged by what they've seen from these new signings?
Yeah, and I think even just speaking to David there, I think you can see there's an excitement around the new players. I think a lot of options in the forward positions, and we've seen it today with different players coming in and out, and you're trying to get that gel of players. But really, really good performance from Dundalk's point of view, and also I think Bose will be happy enough, Bose fans watching in as well, I'm sure will be happy enough with their performance today as well.
Yeah, the coverage today, I've got my Twitter machine here with me and I almost needed gloves. It's been on fire this afternoon. And I think, look, supporters can't be here, unfortunately. I know the whole Watch LOI service has been set up for the season coming, but these sort of streams are so important, aren't they, to keep the League of Ireland fan in touch with the league.
Exactly, and I think the League of Ireland has been growing over the last number of years. You've got a lot of fans wanting to come to the game, so unfortunately with the way things are in the world at the moment with the pandemic, it's nice to be able to provide these streaming services and give them the opportunity to see firsthand new players who have come into both of their clubs, and obviously, as you said, the quality that was there today is a good match all around for them to be able to watch.
Yeah, you mentioned the new players coming in, and I said it during the commentary to you, it's exciting to see international players coming in. In Dundalk's case, they're internationals like Rivas Jurkovskis and Sonny Natastat.
Yeah, exactly. And they get to see them, as I said, firsthand. Players coming around from around Europe is always going to be good for the league. As we mentioned, we've seen on Twitter, players are fans tuning in from all over the world, which is great to see. I think it puts the League of Ireland up on that platform for everybody to see. I think we in Ireland have seen the quality that's been in this league over the years. So for everybody else around the world to now be able to tune in and see those players in action, I think can only be a good thing for the league.
That's it. Thank you very much, Stephanie. Thank you very much for your contributions this afternoon on co-commentary. You're superb. That's it, everybody. Listen, thank you very much for tuning in today. We're going to leave you with a short video to promote the new academy system here at Dundalk FC. We hope to see you back here at Oriel again for the next stream, next home stream in the league, which will of course be the Finn Harps match on March 22nd. But for now, thank you very much for joining us. We've really enjoyed bringing the game to you. I hope you've enjoyed it as well.
It's that long ago, Taylor Crisp were 12p, and the smell of Bovril and deep heat etched in my memory. O'Neill, Lawler, Lawless, Malone and McHugh. Oh, five-man defence you couldn't get through. Wise, Murray, Cleary and the gent Barry Keogh. A midfield 10 times better than from St. Pat's in the Bows. Mary McGillicott shouting, come on Dundalk! Another goal from Desi Gorman, the Dundalk Hawk. Lean Cry from Eddie White, being mascot against Bray. As a child my only ambition was to sign up and play. I wasn't good enough though, but these lads were. Can you follow in their footsteps and be the next Dundalk star?
Premier Division League of Ireland titles.
12 FAI Cups.
7 League Cups.
The highest ranked Irish club in the European football.
Forget FIFA. Play with Dundalk for real. Dundalk FC Academy. A new start. For new stars.